You think this is cute? You think he's bitching? Is that it?
The Howard Stern Show. You're listening to The Howard Stern Show. Okay, you're listening to The Howard Stern Show. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the show. It's Thursday something, May 20th. May 20th, Robin?
May 20th.
May 20th. Look at that.
I'm shocked that you know.
Well, I want people to know, too. Whatever I know, you should know. So, I'm watching TV yesterday, and, you know, they got this story, like it's like the biggest story ever, that Rosie O'Donnell and Tom Selleck actually had a real conversation on her show. Now, I'm thinking about this. I go, imagine how bad television has gotten, where people get excited because two imbeciles have an actual discussion about what they believe.
Right, they went off script.
And if you watch the discussion, the two of them are like idiots. It's like watching two retards fight and discuss an issue. Tom Selleck has to go, you are stupid. You know, he tells her, you know, your ideas are stupid. I mean, I never saw a more disjointed conversation in my life. I never saw two people more uncomfortable with actually being real.
Like somebody not putting the words in their mouth.
Yeah. I mean, every day we do a show like that. But when Rosie, who is so scripted and so fake, I mean, I've told you a million times already what a fake she is. In real life, she's a horrible person. She's mean to the people she works with. She's mean to people at a pool at the Four Seasons. I met a guy 2 seconds after he was berated by her. She growled at him like an animal. Because he had the nerve to go over and say he was a big fan. He just said, this guy was so non-offensive. He went over and just said, Rosie just wanted to say hello and tell you how much I love your show. And she went, like that. Can you imagine doing that to another human being? You got to be some sort of animal to do that. And this is the queen of nice. And Tom Selleck is so, I don't know, such a bad debater. That he doesn't turn to her and says, how dare you have a conversation about gun control when you sell guns for a living? Which is what she does. She said to Tom Selleck, you represent the NRA. You're a member, so therefore you're a representative.
You're a spokesman.
Spokesman. And he said, look, I'm not a, actually, he's not a dopey guy, Tom Selleck. And the guy's a gentleman. He came there to promote a movie. Rosie O'Donnell was claiming that she told him ahead of time they'd be speaking about the NRA. And, of course, he says, they're lying. And, of course, they're lying. He wouldn't have gone on there if he had to do an NRA discussion. She's lying. Her people are afraid to tell her the truth. Because she'll fire them and yell at them. Everyone walks around there. I know for a fact everyone walks around there like
on this,
like on eggshells, yeah. I know it for a fact. It's no secret that she's a bitch.
No picnic over there with Rosie.
And by the way, I don't call women bitches because they are powerful women. I call men bitches when they're mean. I mean, actually mean. The guy at the pool doesn't work for Rosie O'Donnell. You know? There's no reason to growl at another human being because he's a fan of yours. I mean, that's just really sick. That's a sick, sick, fat broad with lots of issues on the table. And I've always said it. I know the sickies when I see them. I know the hypocrites when I see them. And no one is more hypocritical than Rosie O'Donnell. If Tom Selleck had said, look, you want to have this conversation with me off the air, I'll have it with you for a few minutes because you're very fat and I feel bad for you. But here's the deal, honey.
Rain on my parade.
Honey, you sell guns. I support the Second Amendment. You sell guns. That's it. End of discussion. You're not entitled to talk about gun control.
Unfortunately, Tom Selleck, you know, he's into his own thing. He didn't do research on Rosie.
Yeah. Man, I got plenty of research, Tom. The conversation was absurd. So, but what is shocking to me is that when somebody has a real conversation, you see, her show should be like that every day. She should say what's on her mind, and he should say what's on his mind, but no one wants to buy into that kind of television.
Oh, that's too scary.
It's too weird. And on a similar note, you talk about ambushing. I'm watching a promotional ad for CBS 60 Minutes 2. They've got a second 60 Minutes now. And Charlie Rose is interviewing Madonna. Did you see this tape?
I saw parts of it.
Yeah.
I didn't see the whole thing.
I didn't see the whole thing either, but the Charlie Rose had the cameras rolling while Madonna was bitching and moaning about the chair she's sitting in, the lighting isn't right. And you know what that's about. Listen, if you saw the tape, Madonna looks horrible. She's lost her looks. Mm-hmm. She's 41 years old now, and it's very difficult for a woman at 41 to look good.
Especially when you, you know, lived your life on your looks.
Right. I mean, the camera came in a couple of times. You got scared.
It was a horror show.
Yeah, I had to take the children out of the room.
I thought Morticia had come back.
Yeah, Morticia was back. And listen, she desperately wants to look good. So it was a woman insecure about her appearance. And Charlie Rose showed the whole thing.
Yeah. Now, when did they do that on TV?
Never. So talk about ambushing.
And do you know, they were supposed to premiere with that show for the stupid 60 Minutes, the second one.
Oh, that hasn't been on yet?
60 yeah, Minutes 2? It has been on.
Oh, this is the new season.
They interviewed her months ago.
Yeah.
And they, you know, they've been debating about whether to do this or not. They knew the most exciting footage they had was the stuff that she wasn't...
Or where the camera was rolling.
Right, right. You know, where she wasn't aware that she was going, you know, to be broadcast.
Right.
And they were sitting on it and sitting on it, and they kept saying, well, Madonna was boring. That's why we don't want to...
Use it.
Show it.
Yeah. Well, Charlie Rose and Madonna together, I mean, what electricity is there?
Maybe Charlie Rose is boring.
Well, yeah, exactly. He did a boring interview. Well, one day, Madonna will end up in this studio, of course, looking like Madonna's mother. And I'll get to interview her, and then you'll hear a good interview. Believe me. When I get done with her, you'll go, man, now that was interesting. Ain't going to be no phony British accent going on in here when she's here. Yeah. She looks a little like Madeline Kahn now, doesn't she? Beautiful. You know, slowly but surely, I'm becoming very good-looking compared to some of these people.
You know, like, if we stay around long enough, we will be the prettiest people in America.
Yeah, if we can just maintain. Now, look at you. You're older than Madonna, and you look 50 times better.
You know what was...
You don't have a wrinkle.
I kept saying, you know, like, Barbara Walters stayed around until she was more pretty, more beautiful than Elizabeth Taylor.
That's right.
So we can outlast everybody.
Right.
You can be more beautiful than Brad Pitt.
I'm going to keep going. I got a 9.5 yesterday. Al, you're on the air. Sorry?
Big fan.
Thank you.
How you doing, Robin?
Good morning.
I just wanted to say that on the show yesterday, if you taped it, you can play it back and see that Rosie did indeed say that she'd be doing... continue to do Kmart commercials.
Yeah, I don't have the whole... I wish I had a tape. I'd like to listen to that.
She admitted that she does Kmart commercials.
Oh, yeah. She spoke with... What's the little kid who plays Anakin Skywalker? Jake Lloyd, is that his name?
Yeah.
I refuse to learn that kid's name. I'm not going to learn that kid's name.
You're not
buying into that. No, I'm not. Please. Please.
Yeah, well, right before he stepped off the stage, she shook hands and said, yeah, we'll be doing Kmart commercials together.
Yeah. So she has no
problem. She's going to continue to sell guns.
Exactly.
Go figure that out.
She wants to bite off...
How do you become such a big mouth yenta against gun?
What about hypocrite? That's like too blatant.
I mean, that's nuts. That makes it too. It makes the whole argument too easy. Tom Selleck should just slugged her.
Well, I think he wanted to, but he, you know. Yeah, but I just wanted to make that point. I enjoy your show.
Right.
Keep up the good work.
All right, take care. Peace out. A lot of black guys say peace. That's their thing. I've noticed that.
I don't know what it means.
I talk to black guys. A lot of them say peace.
Said goodbye already.
He said peace.
I love it when, you know, people who've never been to Europe say ciao.
Wow. That's very good.
Ciao.
Chris, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hello.
Yo.
Yeah. Am I on the air now?
Yes.
Hey, how you doing? Just wanted to ask Howard about the Rosie O'Donnell incident. I got into a chat room the other day, and there's a lot of trash talk going on about him, so I stuck up for him for about a good half an hour, but I kept getting booted off.
What did he say?
Talking about.
What did he say?
He says he was in the chat room, but he was...
Yeah, I was in a...
asking about Rosie O'Donnell.
But yeah, no, Rosie O'Donnell has a interactive chat room on, like, Mondays. My girlfriend told me about it. So I got in, and as soon as I got in, I saw people starting... they're saying bad things about Howard, so right away I jumped to his defense and had about a good heated argument with a bunch of these geeks for about a half an hour. And I got booted out of the room a couple times, so I kept coming back in, and I'm like, you know, trying to ask all these people, you know, where's Rosie? I want to talk to her.
Yeah, when I used to chat, one of the most fun things I had to do was to go into, like, the Rush Limbaugh room and goof on people.
Yeah.
And then I realized I was a loser, too. All right, dude, later.
There's nothing about that. I mean,
This guy.
Bad connection.
Bad connection. Who cares? That was the least of my problems with him. I don't know what he's talking about. He's an embarrassment.
But it sounds like the Rosie O'Donnell chat site is an anti-Howard site.
Yeah, that's what it is. Why don't they just call it what it is, anti-Howard Stern site? That's all these people have to talk about is me. Pathetic. Really is. Yeah, James, go ahead.
How you doing, Howard?
Good.
Great show. Star Wars was horrible.
Yeah.
Anybody that thinks otherwise, I'm telling you, they have mental problems.
I believe you're right.
Yeah, we should round up the people who go to see it more than once.
And lock them up.
Anybody who didn't see the movie, don't listen to these people. They got problems.
They do.
And I didn't want to agree with you because, you know, I was a Star Wars fan.
Me too. I didn't want to agree with me.
You were 100% right.
I walked out of there in shock. I said, what happened?
Exactly. No plot, no story.
And I know what some guy said to me, you know, man, you're forgetting all the first three Star Wars movies. Or, you know, like child's, you know, it's a children's story, and you're forgetting. I go, no, it wasn't. There was no children's story.
No, not at all. The first three movies were good for children and adults.
Right.
And this movie, the digital effects, it was like cartoons.
You know what's a weird thing I noticed? Like, I'm watching Entertainment Tonight and stuff, and George Lucas is, like, best friends with Steven Spielberg and Ron Howard. And Steven Spielberg and Ron Howard have to go around talking about how great George Lucas's movie is. It's like they have, like... It's weird. Like Steven Spielberg isn't allowed to say it's a crummy movie, even though it is.
Right, they have a big investment in that.
Ron Howard, too, he won't say it. Ron Howard knows that's a crummy movie.
That Lucas pulled Spielberg's ass out of the fire after he made 1941. Nobody wanted to hire him, and he put him in touch with that Raiders of the Lost Ark.
Oh, is that right?
Sure.
Oh. All right. So something's right. And those guys are going around talking about what a great film it is. The other weird thing is, too, when they photograph celebrities, they videotape them coming out of movie premieres, and the celebrities feel they have to lie about that the movie's good. That's another weird thing.
Well, that's what's going on in Hollywood. Everybody's covering everybody else's ass. Nobody will tell you the movie's bad until later, after it's out of the theater. Yeah.
That's why people are so shocked that Rosie O'Donnell had a real conversation with Tom Selleck, where they actually had a difference of opinion. I can't believe that it's front page news.
The startling thing about it was when Tom Selleck he got into the sentence... I came here, too. And then he was like, oh, crap.
Mm-hmm.
I've got to tell him I didn't come here just because I love Rosie and wanted to talk to her. I've got to tell him I came here to plug a movie.
Yeah, right. Yeah, he had to burst that bubble. Was she acting like she was attracted to him at all during that interview? I need to hear the whole thing. Do we have tape of any of that? I guess not. I don't think any of my hundreds of staff would think to bring that in. That I might want to listen to it. All right, dude. Later.
All right, take care.
Let's live in a vacuum. Dr. Remulak, you're on the air.
Remulak. I am Dr. Remulak. I am Dr. Remulak.
What is it, Stuttering John?
He has a question for you.
Dr. Remulak.
Well, let him ask it this time.
I am Dr. Remulak.
If he has a question for me, he should ask it.
I am Dr. Remulak.
This guy has obsessive compulsive disorder, and I know he can talk to me directly. I know he can. I'm not buying into him talking to you. It's about time he grew up. Because he goes to work and has to do certain things.
He has a whole job. He's a big maven.
Right.
I am Dr. Remulak.
Dr. Remulak, if you have a question for me, you must ask it.
Cat got your tongue?
We're not buying into this today.
I am Dr. Remulak.
See?
Is that the only thing that will come out?
He has a question for me, and the thing is that he has obsessive compulsive disorder. I certainly understand it's difficult, but that time we cured him.
I am Dr. Remulak.
You know you can ask me the question directly. Go ahead.
John.
Yes.
Nope, don't ask. I don't answer him.
John's not here.
I am Dr. Remulak.
I have put a gag order on John.
John can't help.
Dr. Remulak, go ahead.
I'm Dr. Remulak.
Is this about your illness?
Is it a good question, John?
It's about you know, what you dreamed about last night.
What?
He was close enough you dreamed about Africa and numbers.
I'm not answering until he asks me.
I am Dr. Remulak.
I have a very interesting answer to that, believe it or not.
Oh, Dr. Remulak, maybe you better ask.
Dr. Remulak, I'll give you one last opportunity to ask me directly.
What did you dream?
progress, Dr.
That's
Remulac.
Progress.
I am Dr. Remulac.
Now I have to say it 50 billion times.
So Dr. Remulac.
I'm Dr. Remulac.
So Dr. Remulac wants to know what I dreamt last night?
Yeah.
What'd you dream?
I didn't have any dreams, Dr. Remulac.
That you remember.
That I remember. What was your dream?
Africa.
You dreamt about Africa.
Why would you think Howard dreamt about Africa?
Do you think that I would share a dream with you?
I am Dr. Remulac.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think this has been a big day for Dr.
Yes.
Remulac.
Yes.
He's going to have to touch so many things today.
He won't even be able to get to work.
Because he touches fire hydrants, that's one of his things.
Right.
He'll be touching it all day.
Right. Fire hydrants are the dirtiest things.
I'm Dr. Remulac.
We know who you are.
I'm Dr. Remulac.
Ask him how the name Dr. Remulac came about.
How the name Dr. Remulac come about?
Don't know, really. Don't remember.
Oh, come on. Isn't it from that Saturday Night Live skit?
Probably.
Remulac, yeah.
Ooh,
spoke to Robin.
I'm Dr. Remulac. I'm Dr. Remulac. I'm Dr. Remulac. I'm Dr. Remulac.
Did you hear the panic that set in?
I know. What's going to happen now?
Ask him what's going to happen that he spoke directly to me and Robin.
What's going to happen now that you spoke directly to Howard and Robin?
John, no. I have to walk backwards for like a half hour.
He's funny, too, because he sounds kind of like Stephen Wright.
I know.
Hey, Dr. Remulac, you said that you'd come in soon. I mean, is that still going to happen?
Maybe. July?
Yeah?
That'll be great. The actual arrival of Dr. Remulac.
Something to live for.
Yeah. I was going to kill myself, but now I'm going to stay alive. I have two reasons to stay alive. Maybe Rosie O'Donnell will have another real conversation with somebody, and it could be on the front page of the newspaper. And Dr. Remulac's coming in.
I am Dr. Remulac.
All right. Thank you, Dr. Remulac.
I am Dr. Remulac.
It's Dr. Remulac. All right.
He actually broke through and spoke to us.
Yeah. What did he think, John, that I had the same dream as him?
Yeah, I think so. I mean,
he dreamt about Africa?
Africa and numbers.
And numbers.
Yeah.
He's tortured. You know what? When I had that thing, OCD, the best time of my day was being asleep.
Oh, yeah.
You know.
Did you ever have it in your dreams?
I don't remember.
Because I even get it in my dreams when I'm really? Touching something, you know.
Oh.
But that's what I'm saying. It sounds like Dr. Remulac is having it in his dreams.
Yeah, I don't think I ever had that. I got to tell you that. If I did, I blocked it out. What a life. Isn't it great when you have one?
World,
isn't it great? So, yeah, it's on the front page of the newspaper. Rosie shoots from the left. Who cares? I mean, it's unbelievable. At least the guy in the New York Post happened to point out that she's a chauffeur, a gun salesman. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Amanda, look at the amount. I would like to get this kind of press.
She's doing this is because it's some liberal agenda she can push and become more popular with that wacky audience of hers.
I know.
Oh, look, Rosie's taking care of us.
Yeah, they were all cheering and stuff. Meanwhile, they all probably own guns. I don't know what they're cheering about. I'm with Tom Selleck, man. I want to have a gun. Are you crazy?
And Tom Selleck's not shooting up any schools.
No, what did he do?
He's not the problem.
Yeah, he wants to own a gun, the guy. What's wrong with that?
Even the NRA is not the problem.
Right.
But that's, you know, that's another one of those scapegoating kind of things. Rosie makes herself look good. And Tom Selleck's got to suffer.
Yeah. And Tom Selleck, by the way, didn't want to even get into it with her. So he's just sitting there like, look, I'm not going to get you. This is a simplistic debate. I mean, what the hell are you talking about? I'm talking about the Second Amendment.
Right.
Here.
You're going to talk about kids with guns like anybody wants kids to have guns.
Right. Yeah. Like Tom Selleck. Now Tom Selleck's for the kids getting guns and shooting the schools.
According to Rosie.
Right. And she simplified it down to that. But, of course, Rosie's been responsible for the sale of more guns than anybody on the planet now that she chills for K-Mart.
Yeah, she's made them a very successful company.
You're not kidding. Yeah, good work. Patrick, you're on the air.
Good morning, Howard.
Hey.
Greetings from Rome.
Right.
Rosie O'Donnell, such a hypocrite. Tom Selleck was biting his tongue. I could see he wanted to dive over the desk and grab her by her fat head.
Although, you know what I think? I don't think Tom Selleck's a real bright guy. I don't think he was biting his tongue. I don't think he even knew what to say.
Right.
He got hit off guard. You know, when you want to interview Rosie, you can't ask her about being a dyke.
Oh,
you know what I mean? She's got all kinds of ground rules for her.
Oh, yeah, there's all kinds of things you can't bring up about Rosie.
You know, he makes a very good point. There was another avenue Tom could have gone up.
You know, book me on that show. It's time for me to do the Rosie O'Donnell show. I might, you know what I might do? Maybe I'll just walk over there and demand to go on. I want to debate her on gun control.
Yeah, I'd like to see you get on.
What time is she on?
Hey, Howard.
What time do they take that show? It's live, right?
Yeah.
So
what
it's
time?
11 o'clock.
10 to 11.
Yeah.
From 10 to 11?
10 to 11.
So we're on the air. Why don't I just walk over with a microphone? Well, how far is her studio from here?
Howard, it's right over at NBC. It's 5 to 6 blocks away.
All right. Get me a remote mic. I'll walk over and say, hey, now this, here, I'm ready to debate
ready?
Rosie
do
about
you
gun control.
Debate guns?
I'll go over there.
Howard, that would be so awesome. I wish you...
Let's do it.
You won't get in.
Hey, Howard.
Why not? Maybe they'll let me in.
They might let him in, Robin.
Okay. No. All right. You people are living in a dream world. You think Rosie doesn't want to have an ambush situation?
Why don't they let me ambush her?
She wants to be where she's in control.
Like, I was watching it on TV with my daughter, and she's, you know, the report on it. We didn't actually see the show. It's like waiting for Haley's Comet for something good to happen on that show. Something finally good happened. So my daughter says to me, why didn't Tom Selleck crush her? And I said, you know why? He's an actor.
He was shooting blanks.
Yeah, I said, now you put me on there, not to pump my own gizmo up here in front of your kids, but I'm telling you, I would have crushed that bitch.
Hey, Howard, great Saturday show, Howard.
Hey, thanks, man. We got a great one coming up this Saturday. As a matter of fact, remember when Baba Booey and Benji wrestled in here just like last week, the big rematch? I know it sounded good on the radio, but... Dude, it's built for television. Wait till you see this. Wait till you friggin' see this.
Hey, Howard.
It's the sickest goddamn thing. Those two idiots. Gary lifts Benji, who weighs over 300 pounds, flips him like it's nothing.
Baba Booey.
I got to say, Baba Booey's in great shape.
Baba Booey.
The other thing I want you to see this week and pay particular attention to is this guy in our audience. He's not a professional animator or anything that I know of.
He's not?
Maybe he is. But it's a cool new cartoon. With featuring all of us. A guy did a great job on it. And if you give me his name, I'd give him a plug, too. He's cool. We got that. And what else we got coming up? Lesbian dating game is real hot.
That's with Jenna Jameson and Nikki Tyler.
Yeah, and we went out and shot a whole bunch of stuff around that.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is all cool stuff. Lots of cool stuff. Gary Garber with Joe Pesci. You got a
good interview. Joe's great.
Yeah, we wait till you see him. It's just a really good show this week. It's all brand new.
The one with Stuttering John and Billy Crystal, too.
Yeah, that's going to be in there.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's cool. So
hey,
we got some good stuff. Yeah, and you know what? Like around 9:30, why don't you give me a microphone, and I'll walk over to Rosie O'Donnell's studio, and I'll say, hey, I'm here now. Why don't you talk to me? Come back on control. Come on. I'll sit down with those fat yentas and mix it up a little bit, and I'll bring up her sexuality. I'll bring up everything.
Go to toe.
I'm going
to
say, hey, you wanted to... Hey, listen, since you're...
an open and honest conversation.
Yeah.
Hey, Howard.
And by the way, when I go on, Gary, go out and buy me a cowboy costume with 2 6 guns. You know, I want to wear pistols.
How about, you know, like those gun belts that you wrap
like
around?
The Mexicans,
yeah.
Like the Mexicans do?
Yeah, like a pistolero. Yeah, bandolero. Bandito. The frito bandito.
Howard.
Yo.
Let me tell you how many jelly beans are in her head for...
Go ahead. Let's do that. We still got that set up. How many jelly beans do you think are in Rosie's head?
Oh, about 3,000.
All right, Gary, come in. Is he high? Is he low?
Close enough for tickets?
Let's hold on. I'm going to get the answer. You might have hit it on the head.
Cool. Hold on 1 second, Howard.
Uh-oh.
Hold on. Gary's got to go look it up. He's forgotten.
I don't remember.
There it is. It's spinning right now as we talk.
Hey, joke man. I got a joke for you.
Just give me that number one more time, Howard.
3,000.
He is. I can tell him if he's high or low?
Yeah.
He's low.
Oh.
Wow.
He has more than 3,000.
I'm sorry, my friend.
I want a joke man for the joke.
All right. If you stump the joke man, what do you want?
Woodstock tickets. They live in Rome.
See, that's too easy. Oh. Just, all right. Is it a real joke?
Yeah.
All right, go ahead.
How do you tell the difference between an oral and a rectal thermometer?
No, I really don't know that. What is it?
The taste.
I see. The taste, sir.
I know that one.
All right, thank you. I don't even care how you tell the difference.
I knew he was going down the wrong alley if he really wanted tickets.
Yeah, I showed him. Those are my 6 guns.
Give me the tickets.
That's my special talent.
But you notice how that does, you know, he doesn't laugh when he delivers that punchline.
No.
I laugh, I'm
it's
in
a joke.
Trouble, but I'll laugh, I'm in trouble.
The taste.
It's only a joke when I tell it. Every time it's funny.
Everyone knows I put that on Hokey Smokey. I wrote that joke. Okay? End of sentence.
It's also on pet jokes.
Right. There you go.
Man, look inside.
by two women at once. The best nose in show business, Howard Stern.
You're going to hear about some woman's going to call us today and tell us how her sick and dying kid tried to meet Oprah, but Oprah wouldn't meet with her.
Really?
Yeah.
You know, Oprah's going to become a professor?
A professor? Yeah. A professor of what?
She's going to be teaching at Northwest University with Fulton.
Yeah, like she knows anything.
I think she'll stand there with Betty.
She's going to teach something. She's now a professor.
The two of them are going to be in the school.
Yeah, that's beautiful. I love that. Oh, Professor Oprah. Someone ought to teach her how to keep her mouth shut and not eat so much. Bob Guccione Jr. will be here. There's a kid who whose father owns Penthouse Magazine. All he had to do was be nice to his dad,
no,
and he would have been set for life.
Get along with his father. What is the problem?
None of those kids can stay close to their father. One of them almost did it, but...
Yeah, he was actually working for his father, and his father had given him an apartment.
Mm.
And now he's lost the apartment and the job.
Here's Frank Gifford.
I just want you to know, Howard, that Kathy and I have said a prayer for you.
Thank you, Gifford. One of our listeners has a tape of the Rosie O'Donnell show from yesterday. You want to listen to it?
Okay.
I've decided I'm going to do the bit. At 9 o'clock, I'm going to get in my car, drive over to the Rosie O'Donnell show where they tape it, and tell them I'm available to come on the show and debate her about gun control. If she wants to have a real conversation, I'm going to bring up everything I know about her.
Mm-hmm.
I want her to now handle a professional debate, not some deer in the headlights like Tom Selleck. I've never seen a guy who can't talk because it's Tom Selleck.
Well, yeah. Guys lived a charmed life.
Yeah, I mean, geez, did he lose the ability to think?
I don't think he ever developed it.
Wasn't he, like, trying to pass himself off that he was going to run for Senate for a while? Like, he was even...
I think, yeah, he was getting a little political there for a few minutes. Mm. But, you know, that was before anybody saw this.
Hey, boy, I've never seen a guy get beat up by a woman so bad. Hi, Mrs. X.
Hello.
This is Mrs. X.
Actually, it's Miss.
Ms. X.
Ms. X.
So, can you play us the tape?
Sure, you ready?
You feel like hearing this, right?
Sure.
Yeah. Okay.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
Here we go.
Okay, we're back with Tom Selleck, who is a member of the NRA. 3 months ago, you joined the NRA.
In here?
I joined to do an ad because, I've done a lot of consensus work for, like, the last 7 or 8 years. And what disturbs me, and I think disturbs a lot of Americans, is this whole idea of politics nowadays, which is seems to be if you disagree with me, you must be evil. As opposed to if you disagree with me, you must be stupid. That's very American. But the demonizing of a group called the NRA is very disturbing. And that coupled with the idea that government is getting into the idea of suing. We did it for noble reasons with tobacco. I think it was a mistake. Then they moved to gun makers. Now they're suing television shows. And Oliver Stone, there's a suit on his movie. I think the First Amendment and the Second Amendment and all the Bill of Rights are extremely important. And somebody needs to stand up at times where maybe some of our politicians are demagoguing issues. Reasonable people should disagree in this country. We should celebrate that, not consider it a threat.
Right, but I think that the reason that people are so extreme against the NRA is because the NRA has such a militant strength, especially a power in Washington, to veto or to stronghold any sensible gun law. They have been against every sensible gun law until yesterday, including trigger locks, so that children, which there are 500 a year that die, don't get killed.
I'm not a spokesman for the NRA. In fact, all I can tell you is I was a member when I was a kid. I was a junior NRA member. I learned firearm safety. And from what I see in the last 3 months, they don't do a lot of the stuff that you assume they do.
Well,
they are for trigger locks. They're for a lot of things, as long as they're voluntary.
Well, they're against the registering of guns. We have to register cars. Why shouldn't we register guns so that when a crime is committed, we can trace who has owned it?
You know, I understand how you feel. This is a really contentious issue. Probably as contentious and potentially as troubling as the abortion issue in this country. All I can tell you is rushes to pass legislation at a time of national crisis or mourning, I don't really think are proper. And more importantly, nothing in any of this legislation would have done anything to prevent that awful tragedy in Littleton. What I see in the work I've done with kids is a troubling direction in our culture, and where I see consensus, which is what I think we ought to concentrate on in our culture, is
what's he talking about?
Argues anymore whether they're conservatives or liberal, whether our society is going the wrong
direction.
He's
dumb as a post.
They may argue trying to quantify how far it's gone wrong or why it's gone that far wrong, whether it's guns or television or the internet or whatever. But there's consensus saying that something's happened. Guns were much more accessible 40 years ago. A kid could walk into a pawn shop or a hardware store and buy a high-capacity magazine weapon that could kill a lot of people, and they didn't do it. The question we ought to be asking is, look, suicide is a tragedy.
And
it's a horrible thing, but 30 or 40 years ago, particularly men and even young men, when they were suicidal, they went and unfortunately blew their brains out. In today's world, someone who is suicidal sits home, nurses their grievance, develops a rage, and is just as suicidal, but they take 20 people with them. There's something changed in our culture. That's not a simple...
But you can't say that guns don't bear a responsibility. If the makers of the 10-million assault rifle, why would the NRA be against assault rifles? This is a gun that can shoot 5 bullets in a second. This is the gun that those boys brought into the school. Why the NRA wouldn't say, as a matter of compromise, we agree, assault rifles are not good.
I can't speak for the NRA.
But you're their spokesperson, Tom. But you have to be responsible for what they say. But if you put your name out and say, I'm Tom Selleck.
Don't put words in my mouth. I'm not a spokesperson. Remember
how Tom said
you'd be, now you're questioning my humanity.
No, not your humanity. I think you're a very humane man.
Okay,
I'm saying
well,
that if you
say I disagree with you, but I think you're being
stupid. But you can't say that I will not take responsibility for anything the NRA represents if you're saying that you're going to do an ad for the NRA. You can't
really?
Say that. Do you think you can?
Look, there's, you know, you're carefully skirting the issue. It's an act of moral vanity, Rosie, to assume that someone who disagrees with your political agenda to solve our problems cares any less or is any less...
I never said you cared less.
Well, let me
I don't think you cared less, nor do I think the men in the NRA cared less. I
the
simply
women
said,
too.
And the women. I simply said, why can there not be a compromise? On the
there issues? Is a compromise.
What?
There's a compromise in enforcing laws. There's a compromise in not allowing kids with guns in school. There's the problem is, and what you don't seem to realize, you seem to have some sort of... Look, we all hang out with people we agree with, and you have a very one-sided view of the fact. What you don't understand
as
is the, laws that...
As does the NRA, and the people you hang out with in the NRA have a one-sided view as well.
I hang out with people in the NRA.
Okay, well, you're saying I hang out with people with my views. I'm just saying...
I said people tend
we
to
We all tend to. The NRA does, and the un-NRA does.
You know, this is a nice one-sided conversation, but you keep interrupting me. Remember how civil you said we were going to be?
I let you talk for 4 minutes without saying one thing. I did. I didn't say one thing. I simply asked a question about the what their philosophies are, and you don't want to.
I told you. When do you want to get to television and violence?
I agree.
Game shows.
I agree. Game shows.
And how do you reconcile? What
you mean, video games? I agree.
Let me just say.
I agree.
What you're really talking about, and what I'm talking about. Is are we a responsible enough society?
She agreed.
Television in terms of guns.
She agreed with nothing.
To be this free. That should frame the debate. My answer, unfortunately, in this culture, is probably not. But I'm going to go down with the civil liberty ship in all the Bill of Rights and apply them equally. That's the way I feel. You can ask me specific questions about anything, but it's simply stupid political rhetoric.
Well, it's not stupid political rhetoric. You also have freedom of speech, but you're not allowed to scream fire in a crowded movie theater because it threatens the safety of other people. Assault weapons threaten the safety of other people. There's no reason, in my opinion, to have them. You want to have a hunting rifle? Great. You want to have a handgun?
Do you really think the Second Amendment is in the Constitution to guarantee hunting and target shooting? Do you really think that's what the Second
Amendment is? I think the Second Amendment is in the Constitution so that we can have muskets when the British people come over in 1800. I don't think it's in the Constitution to have assault weapons in the year... 2000.
Why not?
But I'm wrong.
Well, the government has assault weapons. You better have.
You know, I mean, this is the problem. Here's what happens. There's people with opposing views. There is no compromise. Because you feel attacked, I feel attacked. You feel misunderstood.
I haven't attacked you.
Well, I think that in a different...
I disagree with you.
And I've disagreed with you as well. But mine comes in the form of attacking...
I haven't mentioned assault weapons once. I haven't mentioned a lot of things once. I just... The nature of this debate is... I didn't come on your show to have a debate. I came on your show to plug a movie. That's what I'm doing here.
And that's what we did.
If you think it's proper to have a debate about the NRA, I'm trying to be fair with you.
As but I am trying to.
Absurd. You're calling me a spokesman for the NRA.
Tom, if you're a celebrity and you're doing an ad that says I am the NRA, then what should have been
have
a
brief? Have you read the ad?
I have read the ad.
Good.
Did you read the ad?
I said them. I read what I said.
Okay. Well, I do too. And, you know, this is not supposed to be a personal affront, and it's not. I don't think
well,
that
it's certainly
you...
very entertaining. Look at the audience. They're just laughing and having a great old time.
Well, it's a serious subject. I don't think it's a lot to laugh about.
Ugh.
That's fine.
All right. Well, this has not gone the way that I had hoped that it had gone. But I would like to thank you for appearing anyway, knowing that we do have differing views. I was happy that you decided to come on the show. And if you feel insulted by my questions, I apologize because it was not a personal attack. I was meant to bring up the subject as it is in the consciousness of so many today. That was my intent. And if it was wrong, I apologize to you on a personal level.
It's your show, and you can talk about it after I leave, too.
So I thought I would give you an opportunity to discuss your side of it. This is what I hoped that I did. And if it was wrong, then I'm sorry for that. All right. Obviously, it didn't do much good. But... The Love Letter is a great movie with Kate Capshaw, Tom and Ellen DeGeneres. That is the reason you're here, and I thank you for coming to talk about it. It opens on Friday. Tom Selleck, we'll be right back with Jake Boyd.
She is such a fat cow.
She does a lot of good stuff, though, for people.
Like what?
Name it.
Doesn't she give a lot to charities?
Doesn't matter. When you sit by the pool at the Four Seasons stuffing your fat head with whatever it is, she gives to charities... Because she'll put out a doll and her audience will give to charities. She doesn't give to charities. And when she sits by the pool and some, like, old guy walks up to her and says, hey, I'm a big fan, and she growls at him.
Well,
I've seen it. I've seen her do it.
All right. Well,
all right? I don't even care. You could give $10 billion to charity.
There's no reason to treat an individual.
No, I
that doesn't erase that acting like a jack-off because you're famous. And Tom Selleck is... a gentleman, and would not even, and not only is he a gentleman, he's a dopey gentleman. He's not a bright guy, okay? Not every actor is bright. In fact, most of them are dumb. You got to be a little dumb to go into acting, because what are the odds of making it?
Look, he's a good-looking guy. Yeah. He looks good on camera.
He's a himbo.
He's there.
And he likes to go out with his buddies and shoot guns.
Yeah.
And there's nothing wrong with that. I like to do that as well.
And he doesn't like to think a lot. You know, he's fine.
Right. When you're shooting, you ain't thinking. And I know anytime I'm not thinking, I'm happy. I've gone out with my buddies. I've shot off assault weapons.
Mm-hmm.
I've shot Uzis. And I got to tell you something. It makes me feel very masculine. It makes me feel good about myself to hold an Uzi in my hand and unload.
And if you want to own one, you want to own one.
Yeah. I want to own one. I had to sit there like a girl and shoot my friend's Uzi. All right?
I didn't have my own Uzi.
How do you think I felt?
Can I borrow your Uzi?
And I don't need Rosie O'Donnell telling me I can't own an Uzi. But let me tell you something. I'm going to go over there to that show today. Unless I get really dopey and tired. Which is a good opportunity.
What's going to be your topic of debate?
The NRA. I'm going to talk to... Well, first of all, I'm going to talk to Rosie O'Donnell about why is she a hypocrite? How come she didn't bring up to Tom Selleck that she is a shill for K-Mart? K-Mart, who sells guns. Mm-hmm. What is she talking about? You don't sell... He might be a member of the NRA. She's a gun salesman. K-Mart sells guns.
He's not selling guns.
Did you notice?
Selling guns.
Did you notice what she said? Oh, if you want to have a gun to go, pistol shooting or rifles, that's okay.
Hunting.
Because the K-Mart probably told her, oh, we just sell guns for hunting. Those guns aren't for hunting. Those guns are for shooting.
You can kill a person with a hunting gun.
Yeah, I like how she's like now making a distinction because she's trying to rationalize her own participation in the sale of guns.
Like a hunting gun will avoid a person.
She's a bull artist. Bull S. Bull. Sh.
Oh.
Beep. artist.
I'm not your PR person. I just thought I'd provide you with the...
No, you did a great job. That was nice. That was nice of you.
Okay.
I don't want to get into a debate with you. On a personal level, I apologize.
It's better if you can watch it because his facial expressions are amazing.
Yeah, I saw it on TV a little bit.
He's incredulous.
Yeah, he's like...
How dare you?
Yeah.
Nobody's ever brought anything up to me.
I like that it's a front page story because nobody on TV ever has a real conversation with a celebrity. Mm-hmm. You know, except for me, and that's why most publicists won't bring anybody in here. All right, thanks.
Anyway, hey, loved your movie, F. Jackie.
Right.
Bye.
Thank you. So, what I was thinking of doing is I found out, like, it's just a couple of blocks from here where she tapes.
Mm-hmm.
Get in the car. I'll get the walkie-talkie so I can talk to you. I'll get in there. I'll walk up, and I'll say, I'm available now to debate Rosie O'Donnell on gun control.
I hope they don't hurt you. Mm-hmm. They could be violent.
I'll bring a gun. I'll whip out my Uzi. So, drive over. Get on the walkie-talkie. Hello, walkie-talkie. I'll say, why don't you put me on? I'm not Tom Selleck. I'll have...
Talk about guns?
And I'm going to bring up, you know, some sexual issues.
I didn't appreciate the way Tom handled the situation yesterday.
Yeah, I just kind of feel like Tom Selleck asked me to drop by and debate you. maybe a professional communicator might fare a little better. Somebody who argues for a living.
When they know what's going to happen.
Yeah. So I'll ambush her.
Yeah.
And let's see what
see
she
how
does.
You do.
Guarantee you they throw me out of the building.
Yeah. Let's see how you do under this under these circumstances.
Now, if she has some balls, she'll put me on.
It is on everybody's minds. Let's continue the conversation,
yeah.
Rosie.
Yeah, and I'll debate her, you know, in front of all those fat cows in her audience who sit and applaud everything she says. I don't mind. I don't mind being outnumbered. You know, I don't care.
Assault rifles.
I brought up assault rifles. What is that? Cheers. She sells guns for a living. You know, there's no getting around that. End the debate. I win, you lose. Unbelievable. Yeah. Hey, Shelby, you're on the air.
Hi, Howard. I just wanted to bring up another hypocrite in Hollywood is Rob Reiner, because he's been on all of these talk shows since the Columbine incident, and he's talking about how people who promote violence and the directors in Hollywood are so horrible, and I think he actually called them scum suckers, yet he has directed two movies that are based on Stephen King novels.
Yeah.
I'm not sure he hasn't brought that up to Stephen King when he directed Stand By Me and Misery.
Honey, he's Meathead.
Yeah, exactly.
You know?
Exactly.
This is a guy who makes his living because there's no censorship in this country, and he's calling for censorship.
Right.
He's Meathead. I'm telling you, you cannot idolize people in Hollywood. They're dumbest people. Listen, I get to go to some of these parties once in a while with Hollywood people. You've never, you know, because when you see them and you see them on film and brilliant writers put words in their mouth, you feel like they're special people. I tell you, you stand there online for the bathroom next to them and you talk and you can't believe how dumb they are.
The lights are on, but nobody's home.
They just make a lot of money because that field pays a lot of money if you happen to be one out of a billion that makes it.
Right.
So you start to think they know something. They don't know a thing.
They think they know something.
Yeah.
The thing.
Tom Selleck even thinks he knows something.
They all think they know something.
If you listen to that tape, you hear a guy fumfer around more.
I make a lot of money. I must be brilliant.
If you were an alien and you came down from another planet and you listened to that tape of Rosie O'Donnell and Tom Selleck, you would think Tom Selleck's second language was English. It doesn't even sound like he can put a sentence together, this guy.
Right.
I mean, you never heard anybody talk like that.
He doesn't know what he's talking about.
He doesn't know what he's talking about. He's waiting for somebody to write him something. He was looking around for a cue card.
Well, the segment before she attacked him or they had that discussion, he walked out, and she has these desk themes where she has a different desk every day.
Right.
Well, she has her episode one desk. So he walks out, and, you know, he's trying to promote a movie, and he makes a joke about how he feels like he's spitting in the wind why he's even bothering promoting his movie, because he makes a little side comment about, well, thanks for the Star Wars promotion.
Well,
so you tell me, if that would have been George Lucas who would be for the NRA, there's no way she would have said a word to him.
Right. Well, first of all, no one's going to go see that movie with Tom Selleck.
Yeah.
His career is pretty much over.
Right.
He's an easy target.
He's an easy target.
Exactly.
Right. Your point is well taken.
Maybe Tom Cruise is in all those violent movies.
Yeah.
Right. You know, where he's running around with guns and shooting people and all that stuff. Shouldn't right. say anything about him.
Right.
But that's for Tommy.
But Tommy. I want to see the two of them sleep together. I want to see the lovemaking that goes on. You know, I don't see him. Forget it. All right, thank you.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, I'll bring that up.
Howard.
Well, I'm on Rosio today. I'm going to bring that up.
Okay.
I'm going on today.
Well, I can't wait.
Yeah, I'll be on.
Star Wars about high-tech weaponry and killing each other.
Yeah, she likes stuff, but she's got the Star Wars toys all over the desk. Right. If you really want to get cuckoo and start regulating everything. Start regulating all that?
Aren't there going to be video games based on that where you can, you know, pod race and send your ships out to kill the Death Star?
Look how dumb Tom Selleck is, though. He's like for the NRA, but then he goes, yeah, but a video game. He started to mention video games.
Yeah, he is another one who wants to attack somebody else. Just get it off me.
As long as he can have his hunting rifles. All right, thanks. Exactly. They're all idiots.
Thank you, Howard. I love you.
Love you, too.
Bye-bye.
You know, these guys
have... thought better of it and said, I'll go down fighting for the First Amendment.
Right.
But video games.
Bunch of Hollywood confused, dopey people with low IQs.
Actually, he couldn't even remember video games. He called them game shows.
Yeah, he didn't know what they were. He was all rattled. And she starts screaming, me too, I'm against game shows and video games.
Game shows, you mean video games? Me too.
I'll tell you the truth. I think game shows are the worst example of greed in this country. I'd be for banning those. I've never seen a bunch of...
You want money for nothing?
Makes the country look like a bunch of hard-up sad sacks. Bob Barker.
Come down here and make yourself a fool for a refrigerator.
I know how I'm going on Rosie today. I'm going to bring a big bag of chocolates.
There you go. Bring her some
stuffer.
Ding-dings and yodels.
Yeah, talk about a bad role model. They're stuffing her fat face on bad junk food.
And I'd like to say every time she has a child star in her midst, she tries to feed them.
Fatten them up.
Feed them candy.
Yep. The Wicked Witch of the West. Yikes. Ugh. Yeah, yo, go ahead, Adam.
Howard, I just don't understand where that fat pig gets off. It's just a hypocrite.
Right.
It's ridiculous.
Yeah, it's stupid. It's just a dumb argument. Tom Cruise would have said, you hypocrite. I'm going on there today. I'm a guest on that show today.
You really have the balls to do it, Howard?
I have the balls to do it.
You're going to go there? You're going to dress in the cowboy uniform?
I'm going to... Gary, get me a cowboy uniform. I'm going to wear 2 6 guns.
I want you to get... No, you got to get cat guns and start shooting them off.
Yeah, hop along, Howie.
I'm afraid you're going to get shot.
Yeah, you know what? I don't want to wear the 6 guns because they know those... I worked at NBC, and those security guards at NBC will shoot me.
Yeah.
They're making $4 an hour.
Yeah, but if you shoot a couple of rounds of the cap, they'll have a heart attack.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Did you see Letterman?
What?
Did you see Letterman?
No, what was on there?
Tom Selleck was on Letterman, and Letterman goes to him and goes, so, how's your day been going? And Tom Selleck, I thought he was going to cry.
Really?
Yeah, it was pretty funny.
I missed that. Hey, how did Mary do on Conan? Did anybody see that?
Know.
My movie wife was on Conan. I promoted it yesterday.
I was watching the E! Show.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. I was just wondering how she did.
Didn't see it. But she is such a fat pig, man. She has no right to do that to anybody.
Man, well, I'm going to go over there today, and we'll have a nice debate. Today's round two of the debates.
I don't think she'll let you in.
You really don't think so?
No. Why would she? Because you're going to make her look like a fool.
So what, am I going over there for nothing, Robin?
No, you're going over there to make a statement.
Right. To show you what a coward she is.
Yeah, this is the woman who wants a no-holds-barred discussion only with Tom Selleck.
Right. Do it with me. I'm a big dope. Talk to me a little bit.
Show how it is, man.
Right. Oh, wait.
You'll defend the NRA.
I will not only defend the NRA. I am going to ask her about sex.
Oh.
We're gonna get into a real honest discussion over there. We're gonna talk about eating disorders. We're gonna talk about being rude to your staff.
Growling at people by the pool.
Yeah, I'm gonna bring it all up.
Big fat phony.
Right.
You know they all get in at like 6 in the morning. Do you think they're huddled around the radio right now trying to decide whether to let you on the show?
No, what? I think they're having barricades built.
I am going to be there. I will be at, where do they take?
Rockville Center.
I'll be there at 9 o'clock. I will offer my services today and say I demand a debate.
You're there for the pre-interview.
Yeah, I want to be pre-interviewed.
But don't you think they're sitting around the radio and they're going, well, ratings are down 30%.
No,
they ain't big.
No, okay. No way.
That is not the discussion.
But I will prove today what a coward Rosie O'Donnell is once and for all. I will expose her. All right?
Well, it's about time somebody does it, man.
I bet they're smuggling the set to New Jersey right now. They're going to tape from a new location.
Going on the road.
But you know what I picture? I picture the National Guard laying down sandbags.
Let them do what they want. I will walk in. In my cowboy uniform. And I will debate. I'll debate that fat slob right on TV, live. I will have no notes, no preparation whatsoever. She can go prepare now. And I will show you how it's done. Tom Selleck is a chump. Tom Selleck is as dumb as they come.
Who was she supposed to have on today? Because that's all she'll be prepared for.
Who's on today, Robin? Read that to me. Now that I'm going to be on. I demand to be on first.
Howard, man, you got to do it. You can't let the audience down.
Yeah, I'm not letting anyone down. I'm doing it for myself, not for the audience.
Rosie has on Helen Hunt today.
Good.
And the Backstreet Boys.
Good. I'll panel with all of them. And let them talk about the NRA. And let the Backstreet Boys talk about sex.
Oh, boy.
I question their honesty.
A lot of questions.
Got a lot of questions. I question everyone's honesty. Good. I'm all excited. I wasn't planning on doing a talk show appearance today. I haven't done one in a year, I think.
Well, like I said, man, it's about time someone does it to that fat bitch.
I'll be there. Thank you. Well, there you go, Robin. I have my agenda set before me.
Now we know what we're doing.
Now I know what I'm doing.
Have they gotten that remote truck yet?
They're working on it right now. Is it 9 o'clock yet? Only thing, I got to get my lazy fat ass out of this chair. That's the only thing I'm upset about. I wish they could just whisk me over, like keep me in the chair.
Like in Star Trek, just beam you over.
Just beam me over to the Rosie. Imagine I beam onto the set.
That would be so good.
Yeah. Why don't we write a Star Trek where I beam onto the set of Rosie O'Donnell?
That's the only way to get there.
Next, you're going to hear from a woman who has a dying child, and Oprah won't see her.
Oh, dear.
That's so rude.
Right, would ye? Even Wood Yee knows.
That's so rude.
You bet. You bet. William Shatner will be here tomorrow for all you freaks. Damon Wayans, too, is going to play the gossip game with us. Looking forward to meeting him. Funny guy. Bob Guccione Jr. will be here later in the program because I'll never figure this guy out. All he's got to do
He was born in Clover.
His father's a multimillionaire, and none of those kids, none of them Guccione Juniors, can get along with Bob Guccione Sr.
What is the problem?
What is the problem, Robin?
I don't know. I think I can handle it.
And later today, I'll be on Rosie O'Donnell's program, where I will debate Fat Rosie. That big jelly bean-filled head will have to debate someone who actually won't be a deer in the headlights. We'll see how that goes. But we'll speak to Chantel next.
Let's see if she gets to do a show today.
Yeah. I will be there.
Put on a rerun and she'll stay at home.
She's going to be forced to answer to me. The Grand Inquisitor.
She wants ratings. This would be the way to get it.
Yeah, there's going to be big ratings today with me and Rosie. I'm going to grace her show with my presence. All right, listen. I am going to go over to the Rosie O'Donnell show.
Good. Kick some ass.
I'm going to go over there and say, hey, you want to interview somebody about, let's debate guns? I'll talk guns. Let's talk about how you are a K-Mart shill.
Mm-hmm.
And what do you think of that?
Yeah.
What are the odds of her letting me on the show?
One in a million.
One in a million.
Yeah.
And yet I could get on.
I hope.
Oh, why the hell am I going over there?
It's like that line in Dumb and Dumber when Jim Carrey is told by the girl his odds are one in a million. He goes, yes! You know the chance.
I got a chance. No, I'm going over there to make a statement. Yeah. I'm going to show you what a coward she is. I'm going to show you what a coward. It's easy to take a dope like Tom Selleck, who really has the brain the size of a thimble.
He's got a big head.
He's got a big head, a big pretty face, but he's not a bright guy. You could see he was fumfering around. And you got to admit that he was ambushed. He's sitting there. He wants to promote a movie.
Right.
I will now go over there and say, I would like to ask a couple of questions. A, number one, what is her sexuality? All right, let's find out once and for all. Let's have it admitted to those fat cows who watch her every day. Think she's in love with Tom Cruise.
Like, open and honest discussion.
Yeah.
The odds just went up.
Yes.
One in 10 million.
One in 10 million. What are the chances of her saying that Kmart is wrong and that she will resign from doing those commercials if she's so concerned about guns? I think it's better to be a member of the NRA than it is to be selling guns directly.
Absolutely, yeah.
All right. I will ask her about what she ate for breakfast. And I will ask her why she's so rude to the people she works with if she's the queen of nice. And why is she so rude to people at the pool at the Four Seasons Hotel, which I was witness to?
Uh-huh. Intrepid journalism. Excellent. So
he has some questions.
I will ask her.
Inquiring minds want to know.
I will ask her who she dates.
One in a 100 million now.
One in a 100 million?
Yes. Why hasn't Rosie found love?
Right. After the all these glory. Years. A woman who loves humanity so much, why has she not found love?
I'm looking for the right man. I want Tom Cruise.
So we never hear about a date.
Right.
Is she not dating?
Right.
Yeah, this is warming up. Is Robin going with you?
Robin's going to watch me.
Excellent.
And we're going to have a video camera on me.
There you go.
And I got a truck. I got the CBS truck I'm going over.
I was thinking about, yeah. I was like, the last time he did something like this was when we were in London.
Go ahead.
And it was this whole big radio thing, and Scott Muni.
That's right.
Was over there. And he went to confront Scott Muni.
Yeah.
And I only could hear the whole thing. And Howard was really bold and brave, and he challenged Scott Muni and yelled him down. And I was like, yes, Howard, yes.
But wasn't
and he came back. And I just found out. I mean, it sounded wonderful. It sounded like Howard really stood his ground and made a point. And then a couple of weeks ago, he informed me that he was running the whole time he was here.
Well, the guy was chasing me. He was an ex-Marine. He was going to kick my ass.
And I never knew that. I was so proud of him.
Yeah, you need to watch me.
That's the magic of radio.
Yes, it is. I seemed like I stood my ground.
Looking for an exit.
Listen, I don't get my ass kicked, especially by a guy 20 years older than me. I look like a real fool. Bob, I wish you luck with your new magazine, Gear. I have read it. It's actually really good.
Thanks, appreciate it.
Gear magazine. Yeah, it's good. It's a good magazine. I like it a lot.
Yeah, we're having fun with it.
Yeah, it's men's magazine. Got some good interviews. They got some good stuff in there. And it's hard because there's so many goddamn magazines.
Today, it's incredible.
Yeah, I don't know how you do it.
Getting rid of that Publisher's House Weekly and the stuff like that where you could work on your circulation.
Right.
Yeah,
thanks for depressing me.
Yeah, well, you could fool old people into buying...
Precisely 5 to 9 in the morning.
You could fool old people into buying magazines on some sweepstakes.
Anybody
scam.
Have a K-Mart gun? I feel like, you know, why go to work?
Well,
no Publisher's Clearinghouse.
You know, I don't understand. Just because old people can't figure out that they didn't really win $1 million.
Well, see, you know what the problem was?
Why do we have to give it up?
No. The whole problem was that they all started showing up in Florida.
Right.
Looking for their winnings.
Right.
And the state of Florida then got pissed off.
Oh, please.
And that's what blew it for
everybody. Senile old bastards. What do you make up? You've written your father. What do you write in those letters to your father, by the way? Dear Daddy, I love you, I need you, I want you.
That's private, that's private.
It is private. Will you share those letters with us?
Dear Daddy, I love you, I want you, I need you.
Why don't you publish those letters in Gear Magazine?
Sounds like a song.
Do you apologize to your father? No.
Well, I've apologized for any hurt I've caused him, absolutely sure.
Right.
Yeah, and I mean that sincerely.
Should I call him right now? Would you like a reunion with him on the phone?
I don't think you can quite do it that way, but...
No, very public.
You know, it has to happen. It has to happen in its own time, you know. Listen, I love him. He loves me. We may not be able to talk, but I feel that. And
yeah, can't you just sit in a room together and not talk to each other?
I think we will.
Yeah. I mean, no holidays. What are you doing holidays?
This proves that the cultural blood runs.
Yes.
This is so Italian. You know, I'm third or fourth generation. I don't even know what
are you like
what
dead
generation
to him?
I am.
He is dead to me. You should publish those letters in Gear Magazine. I would
every
like to read
month.
Them. Every month.
Okay,
a letter to my father.
Okay, Dr. Howard.
I don't know. I would buy the magazine immediately.
Exactly. Send your letter.
I think I need another session.
Put an open penthouse. Letter.
Hey, send your letter. Why don't you send it to the penthouse form? Let me ask you a question, okay? Because you would know.
Mm-hmm.
Penthouse form is fake, right?
No, it's real.
You really say that?
Yeah. No, but I when I was there, I used to see letters. You should see the ones they don't print.
Do you think that the people are making them up?
The letters are real. I think the people make them up, absolutely.
Right, okay. All
right. Cool. Yeah. But I don't know. I mean, God forbid some of them aren't.
Right. All right, listen.
The letters I get.
I bet.
Seriously, because we have a file called Nutcases.
Who are you dating now?
It's a very thick file.
Oh, that's where you get your dates?
Are you really looking for a wife? Yeah. Because we can put the word out.
Right. Yeah, listen, first get me adopted, because I need parents. I have a lovely mother. I'll bring her with me.
Who are you dating now?
I'm not dating anybody.
I don't believe that.
No, it's a sad story.
Really?
And did you know the woman who died that the Gooch had been with all those years?
The Gooch Master Jr.? Or the Gooch Master Sr.?
What woman?
Yeah, there was some woman he lived with.
Kathy Keaton?
Yeah, Kathy Keaton,
oh,
you knew her?
Of course, yeah, my father's
wife. Yeah. Yeah. Right, yeah. Yes, 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 that woman.
The woman that died, you know, like, well.
Well, she did die.
Yes, she did. Sadly, she's gone.
Yeah, I knew her very well. Did you go to the funeral?
No.
Good Lord.
I was asked not to go. So I didn't go.
Oh, really? You were told not to go?
Yeah. You were not invited.
Who asked you? Your father?
It came through the company. Just
wow.
So it was his moment of grief. I didn't want to compound it. So
you guys must be nuts together that he doesn't even want you at the funeral. I
like
got.
He can't even see his way clear to let you do that.
What have you said to him? What is the worst thing you've ever said to your father?
What's going on?
Yeah, I mean, something's going on.
I can't remember.
Have you yelled at him?
Oh, sure.
Oh, you two have had real knockdown drag-out?
Absolutely. Never physical.
Never beat up the old man?
No.
Hey, way to go. I don't hit my father.
I don't hit him.
All right, so anyway. Bob Guccione Jr.
I may have spoken to him like that.
Right. Congratulations on Gear. Wish you luck with that Gear magazine. A fashion and pop culture for young men is at your local newsstand. Check it out this month with Cindy Margolis on the cover.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, you can't go wrong with that.
Yeah.
Most downloaded woman on the internet.
She's been on here more than any other one.
She's gotten the highest ratings on the D-Show. Yeah, she's great. All right, we're going to... hold on. Hey, Gary, bring me my telephone.
It's time
I'll do this
go.
With Bob. It's time for me to go.
Baba Booey. Baba Booey.
Now, how do
Baba
I bring
Booey.
This up?
Okay. Hello, Bob?
It's on speakerphone.
It's on speakerphone.
Hold it up to the microphone. If you push the side, really? Talk in, you'll be talking to Andre, who has the other one. He'll be running the board, and you can hold it right up.
Andre, can you hear me?
Loud and clear, Howard.
Now, can I call...
Like you're in space.
You have to wait for that little beep before you talk.
But, Gary, can I call into the show so you can bring it up through the board?
You can do that as well. This is for when we're not near a phone.
Oh, I see.
This is like a backup.
Because I was now going to walk out of here with a telephone.
Yeah.
And say goodbye to you.
Do that, too.
How long does the wireless mic work?
Don't I have to dial a phone number?
No, I'll take care of that. I wasn't sure. I'm sorry.
Because you could walk out of here with the wireless mic and switch to phone.
That's what I thought we'd gone over that, but I guess not.
Well, what is this big dramatic moment?
Well, I'm Wait, about to go confront Rosie
yeah,
O'Donnell.
The phone bit is what I'm... Technology's throwing.
The technology is completely off.
Yeah. Believe it. It throws
we're
us
the dawn.
In other words, my producer doesn't realize it's got to be on the air when I speak.
Oh.
it was like you were talking to us from space. All of a sudden, you were an astronaut.
What I need is Andre's phone, but coming through the board. All right.
This is great.
20 years ago, they sent video from the moon, but we can't get audio from two blocks away.
All right. Let me see. What line am I on?
He'll have to tell you in a minute.
John will tell you what line you're on.
John, what line am I on?
That's not the jackhammer line.
No, you're yes, it is.
I'm sure he's putting me up on the jackhammer line.
You guys better pull another line out.
Is that,
is that me?
Yes. That's me.
You're talking to yourself.
Oh, walkie-talkie.
You know, this is like a Star Trek episode. You have to keep running before you confront yourself.
Howard, don't push that side button now, because then you'll put yourself into walkie-talkie mode.
Let me see about that. Ooh.
I like the effect.
That.
Great. Hey, now.
That's better.
All right, so what I'm going to do is take off
my headphones.
Can you hear me
now, Robin?
Hear you.
All right. Bob, I'm going to go now.
Okay, man, good luck.
Wish me good luck.
I do. May the force be with you.
Bob? I'm going to walk into a commercial break, Robin, but I want you to hear me walk out of the building as I approach the Rosie O'Donnell show.
Very good.
During the commercials, I'll be in my car.
And headed over to Rockefeller Center?
Yes, I'm putting on my jacket now, Robin.
Oh, because we don't want you to get a chill.
Wait a second. Jackie's asking me something. You want to come? All right, why don't you come with me, you big, fat joke man.
Get out of here.
My brilliant self.
Oh, yeah,
I need to be there.
Brilliant.
All right, Bob, where are you going? Are you going to stay and do the show without me? You going to take over? All right, call your father, Bob. Go make up with your father while I do this. Robin, I'm going to take a commercial break. I'll be right back. And the next time you speak to me, I should be outside the Rosie O'Donnell show, demanding to be let on the show.
We'll be looking forward to it.
All right, thank you.
Do you have a pen, Jackie, with your brilliance?
No, I'm not prepared.
Who's going to have time to talk to Jackie? All right. Oh, yeah, we need a copybook for the commercial. Like that. Robin, I'll call you from the car.
All right.
You're listening to the Howard Stern Show.
Hey.
Hi.
All right, so anyway, we're back. Now, let me tell you what's going on. So we just drove over. I'm outside the NBC studios where Rosie O'Donnell tapes her show.
Yeah.
So I figure I'd go in there and ask her, how come if she's so worried about kids with guns, how come she's, hey, can I use this microphone now? Does that work? Hey, hold on, Robin. Let me test this microphone out. I'm about to go on a microphone.
Oh, it might be better. I can see you.
Wait, hold on a sec.
All right.
Let me see. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Oh, this is cool. I got an earpiece and everything.
Oh, great.
All right.
Yeah, well, I see Ronnie. I don't see you.
Do you see all the camera crews out there?
No, they're pointed toward the car. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, look what's doing out there.
Well, how are you supposed to get in?
Hey, what do I do with this? Do I just leave it like that? Yeah, fix me up, Doug. Come on, man. Be my groomer. All right, so listen to this. So we drive over. You just pulled the earpiece out of my ear.
Oh, boy.
Give me the goddamn earpiece. What's the matter with you? You're fired, by the way.
Obviously, Doug doesn't work for Dan Rather. It never happens to him when he goes out.
The good thing he doesn't work for Rosie O'Donnell. She would have just fired him. Anyway, so here's the deal. Hey, give me that thing, will you? Pretty stupid. All right. It's very difficult. I got the mic.
So what do you think will happen if you step outside the car?
I'm going to step outside the car, and then probably some reporter is going to ask me questions. And then I'm going to go in and try and get on the Rosie O'Donnell show because I want to ask the question why Rosie shills for K-Mart if she's so worried about kids and guns. And then I'll look like a real hero, and then I'll go up there, and they'll probably throw me out of the building. But there might be a 1 in a billion chance they'll let me on the show.
It is a public building. I don't think they can stop you from walking into the building.
Oh, believe me, they'll stop me. Public schmubbling. All right, anyway.
For everybody but you. I'm losing you. What's happening?
I don't know, because I'm about to move and actually get out of the car. All right, let me see what happens. If I can't hear you.
Keep that phone close by.
All right, let me see. This is going to be a madhouse. All right, here we go. All right, let me out of this car.
There he goes.
Uh-oh.
Oh, the car's leaving the curb.
Yeah, we're moving. We're moving. All right. This is cool.
All right, all the reporters are, like, following you.
I'll answer the reporters.
On foot.
The reporters need something for the...
Oh, God.
And there's a hot reporter, a blonde. Oh, yeah, baby. Unreal. Somebody open the door, will you?
No, they won't even let you out.
They won't let me out. Ronnie, open the door.
Nobody knows. Ronnie, open the door.
Thanks. All right, here we go. Hi, everybody.
All right, now they're all screaming questions. Oh, my goodness.
Excuse me?
Why are you here today?
The reason I am here, where are you from?
A news organization.
What news organization are you with?
Global News.
Global News?
News. That's not a news organization.
Howard, what are you?
Let me just say something. Let me make a statement.
Oh, my goodness.
All right, let me say something. I'm trying to say it. It's nuts. All right.
You need security.
Rosie O'Donnell is a hypocrite. If kids are getting shot, why is she selling guns?
I have something to say about that.
If five kids were shot today, which I'm unaware of, why is Rosie O'Donnell selling guns through K-Mart? Why is she confronting Tom Selleck? When in fact, she's a gun saleswoman.
What do you say about the kids being shot in Atlanta? What is your opinion about that?
It's a terrible tragedy, and Rosie O'Donnell should resign from the board at K-Mart and stop selling guns on TV.
What questions do you want to ask her?
I want to ask her why she sells guns for K-Mart. She took a big dummy like Tom Selleck, who's comparable to talking to a retarded person, and argued with him when he wasn't prepared. I'm prepared to argue with her. Put me on. But she's such a big, fat hypocrite, she's not going to allow me on that show. Am I right?
That's right, Howard. That is correct. That's right.
All right, be quiet.
Keep the microwave
clear
from
that
him.
Skin, for God's sake. Covered in pimples, Robin. What?
Are you doing this because you really don't like Rosie, or are you doing this because of the issue?
I'm doing it for two reasons. I don't like Rosie, and I'm doing it for the issue. Yeah, what is it?
What exactly is your position on guns?
What is that?
What is your position on guns?
I think people should be allowed to own guns. I don't think guns are the problem. I think we got a bunch of screwball parents. I think we have a society where people don't take responsibility for their own actions. That's my position on guns. What?
Do you think it's unfair for Rosie to do that on a talk show to a guy like Tom Selleck? Do you think it was an ambush?
No, I don't think it's unfair. I certainly talk to guests like that, but at least I'm upfront about it. It was an ambush. When my guests come on, they know they're going to have to talk about everything. Rosie gets you on there under the guise that she's going to talk about Tom's latest movie, and then what she does is she ambushes you, and she takes you by surprise.
She's supposed to be the queen of nice.
Now I'm going to teach her our lesson and ambush her. Ma'am, you are a black woman, right?
Yes.
You had to fight for your rights, right?
Yeah.
I am doing this for all black people. All black people.
Will you go into the building already?
Thank you. Consequences of doing something like that.
I am ready for anything. I am ready for all consequences. I have every right to go there and ask to be on the show.
How are you going to get in the building? How do you get up there? I mean, what are you going to do? You
got to get past the reporters.
Yeah, I can't get past the reporters. That's the problem.
How would you spend your life ambushing people? Why is it so wrong for you?
I don't ambush people. I'm upfront about it. I actually tell people I'm going to ambush them. All right, now we're going in the building.
All right, okay, I see you. Moving forward.
Mayor Dubinsky.
Who's Mayor Dubinsky?
I don't know. Somebody just dropped their coat.
I want your opinion about the kids being shot today. What's your opinion?
Forget that guy.
But obviously,
he just got shot in a high school in Atlanta.
Forget that guy. Go, go.
Terrible tragedy.
Right in here.
Hi, how you doing?
There's an ambush artist.
There's an ambush. Robin, I'm never going to make it.
Oh, my goodness.
So many reporters.
There's the only safe place is in Rosie's studio. Who's in there?
Thank you.
Oh, my goodness.
Thank you.
Who are all those people?
Here we go.
I don't even think you can hear me.
Can you hear me?
There's so much commotion. I can hear you.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
I don't know if you can hear me or not.
I know he can't hear me.
I will ask the security people if I can be let upstairs.
All right.
Can Robin hear me?
Yes.
Hey, how you doing?
Well, somebody tell him yes.
Is that NBC?
Yes.
Can anybody hear me? Gansey, am I on the air?
I am not.
I'm not on the air?
No, you are.
I don't have a feed, so I don't know.
Am I on the air? Does anybody know?
I work at NBC. I'll bring you up to Rosie.
Really? Am I on the air?
Yes, you are.
Okay. Let me ask you a question.
Oh, dear.
Can you call up to Rosie O'Donnell and ask her if I can be on the show today?
They'll bring you up as a guest.
Yes.
All right, go ahead. I'll wait right here for you.
You have to ask one of them, actually.
Who do I ask?
Howard, I'll bring you up as my guest.
I got to ask over here. Hello?
Oh, my. It's bedlam over there.
Hi. Guys, can you call up to Rosie O'Donnell and ask her if I can come upstairs?
Well, she already told us you can't come up, baby.
She already said no?
I knew it.
Well, yes. Oh, okay, hold on.
What?
Robin?
Yes?
Can you hear me?
Absolutely. We've heard everything.
I've been informed by security that I cannot go upstairs.
Oh.
You knew that's what she'd say.
Can you believe it?
Uh-oh, I'm losing him. Where'd he go?
Well, let me make a statement to the press.
Please.
I have been banned from going on the show. Rosie is afraid to confront me.
No!
Rosie is afraid to defend you.
Rosie is afraid to
defend you.
Well, if it's up to the crowd,
they obviously want me to go on.
Yes.
Let me say something. Rosie O'Donnell has banned me from coming upstairs. She's afraid to debate somebody who actually has a brain in his head. And this is a joke. This is, again, Rosie O'Donnell being a hypocrite. She is not willing to debate someone because I would bring up a few things like her K-Mart connection, and she doesn't want that on the air. Thank you. I wanted to prove what a hypocrite she is, and that's what I've done here today. I did not expect to be on the show. Thank you. Robin, can you hear me?
Yes.
It's a madhouse down here.
It makes a difference.
I'm now leaving the building. Well, I'm leaving because I can't get in unless I storm through the door.
Yeah, you better get away from all those reporters, too.
There are a lot of press, Robin. I'm barely able to hear myself think. I feel like Tom Selleck right now. I can barely think.
All right.
Listen to the crowd.
This is amazing.
Who said I suck? Who said that? Who said I suck? Who said I suck? Come over here, honey. I'll kick your ass. Come on over here, honey. I'll kick your ass. I'll kick your friggin' ass right here in front of everybody. Where are you? You bitch. You stupid ass dummy. What was that? Am I going to try again? Hold on a second. Where's my microphone? Give me the microphone. I'm on fire. Hey, dummy.
Can you hear me?
Right. Where's the microphone?
Howard.
Where's the microphone? One second. Where's the microphone?
Gary!
Gary, give me the goddamn microphone. I heard it. Hey, take this. Thank you.
Uh-oh. That mic is not working. No, take the phone back.
Our microphones, once again, don't work, Robin.
Yes, it was perfect.
Robin, I am now back out on the street. The press is demanding a statement again from me.
Take your hat, Howard. Take your hat.
Robin, all I can tell you is this proved exactly what I wanted to prove.
that Rosie O'Donnell will not speak to me because she's afraid to talk about any real issues with someone who can communicate. Am I right or am I wrong? Damn right I'm right. What is it?
Are you gonna try again?
Sure. I mean, what's the point? She's never gonna let me on.
What if you promise to only ask her about the NRA issues and not about other things that
she
might be afraid of you?
We'll talk about that. Gary, you got another microphone for me? No mic. I'm not gonna guarantee her anything. I'll talk about anything I want. I'm not gonna do that. Yeah.
I will.
What?
With this funeral?
Maybe, but I figured I'd give it a shot. I think it was good to do. Thank you. I'm going to get back in my car now. All right, here we go. Robin.
All right, you're coming back.
He lost the microphone. I don't even know if he can hear me.
Uh-oh, he's gotten sick out there.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
All right, here he comes. He's back in the car.
Robin, did you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. I've heard you the whole time.
I'm having trouble talking. I've been yelling so much.
I heard you coughing. I said, you've gone out there and gotten a disease.
We just got back in the car. Jackie, the joke man, almost got stuck.
You know, he would not have been a great loss.
I don't know.
Is he there?
Robin, I don't know if you can hear me, but that was really draining.
All right, get the car moving.
Uh-oh, what are you lowering the windows for? Ronnie just lowered the window.
Oh, he's terrible.
He just opened the window on me.
What, is Ronnie losing it?
I don't know. He's nervous.
All right, now he's pulling away. Thank goodness.
Anyway, what happened was could you hit the security desk?
Yeah. Yeah, I heard the whole thing.
I got there, and this guy already said that they were prepared not to let me upstairs.
Absolutely. I knew that.
But I knew it, too, but I don't care. I wanted to prove a point.
Right. She's not going to debate anybody who knows what they're talking about.
I know. Oh, my God. Did you hear that madhouse?
It was crazy. We could see the whole thing. It was a nightmare. There were more press there.
Hey, Gary, why don't you call in on that phone so we can talk better?
And tell the other guys not to curse while they're holding on to things.
Hold on, Gary. Just dial the phone. That's it. Gary is using his big thumb to dial.
What happened to the truck? Did we have that?
I guess not. Hello? Hello? Can you hear me?
You have a big dial tone over you.
Gary, what have you got on? You got a dial tone.
There's like another line open.
Yeah, Andre, what are you doing?
Andre, you got to put something down over there.
These guys went out of work here, Swift. Guys, you gotta get.
Oh, that's him. Hello?
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 Hello, who's this?
This is Robin.
Robin, we're on here. Hold on, here's Howard.
Okay.
Guys hung up on me, Rob. All right, now I can hear you better.
All right, everything's working perfectly.
So I got out of the car, and I don't know how much you could see.
We could see and hear everything.
Yeah, it was like a madhouse.
Yeah.
And then when I finally got inside, I don't know why our microphone bombed out.
It didn't. It was low, but we could still hear.
Yeah. And then I went up to this guy, that, you know, one of those old black guys that works at the desk.
Yeah, the security guys.
He made some kind of statement that Rosie O'Donnell already said that I should not be allowed upstairs.
So they were listening, they heard, and they immediately informed the building that we were not to be let upstairs.
Right. So, in other words, she's a big coward. She would have had some great television, but it shows you that she's not willing to confront.
She's certainly not interested in entertainment or a real debate.
Is it true that, there was another shooting in Atlanta?
Yeah, in Atlanta, a high school, some kid came in and opened fire. There's not a lot of details. There weren't any deaths, but there were, four or five injuries, I think.
And Hypocrite Rosie is going to keep ignoring the fact that she sells guns through K-Mart.
Absolutely.
Unbelievable.
No, she's going to make everybody else
feel bad.
Yeah.
And feel responsible.
It's everybody else's fault but hers.
Yeah, she's going to make Tom Selleck feel bad, a guy who doesn't have a brain in his head.
All right, I'll tell you the latest thing that our crack staff has done. They put you on the line with all the noise on it.
Oh, they did?
Yeah, the one with the jackhammer noise.
We don't have anybody who knows what they're doing up there. Can you guys transfer me over to a different line? Why don't we take a break?
All right. Here we go. We'll do some commercials.
Hi, this is Tori Spelling of Beverly Hills 90210. I love three things. My dad, my gorgeous bod, and the fact that Howard Stern will never have me sexually.
This is the Howard Stern Show.
Man, I must just tell you, complete exhaustion has set in. I had a coughing fit in the car because I was yelling so much over the... I didn't have a headpiece that worked, Robin.
Yeah, I saw that you just ripped that earpiece out of your ear.
It wasn't working. If it had been working, it would have been fine.
And was the phone only one way you couldn't hear?
I couldn't hear. I kept asking you if we were on the air because I'd have no idea.
Yeah,
I couldn't hear you. I had no idea so much press would be out there.
And I don't think anybody stayed in communication with us who was near you.
Yeah, well. Marconi had better equipment. What can I tell you? Yeah, Matt.
Hello?
Yeah.
It's Frank.
Sorry, Frank.
Okay, hey, Howard, I am so ticked off. So ticked off at this whole situation with Tom Selleck. He may not be the smartest person in the world, but you know something? He was on Regis and Kathy Lee this morning. I saw them both. And, you know, Regis and Kathy Lee conducted it like professionals.
Well, let me tell you something.
I mean, it's disgusting.
Well, she thinks she did something great. She did nothing.
Nothing.
And
great.
If you saw, she wouldn't allow me upstairs. I would have gone on there and blown her away.
Howard, if anybody went up, you know, I mean, this was like, you know, she wouldn't let him have a word in edgewise. It was, you know, he didn't want to tell her to go, hey, F off.
Right.
Shut your mouth. If that was me or anybody else who wasn't promoting something,
mm-hmm.
we would have gotten up and walked the hell out.
Right. I was very serious when I went over there. I wasn't doing it as a joke.
No, let me get over there. Howard, this is the... I don't know what to say.
Yeah, I hear what you're saying. You made your point, and it's a good one. Matt, you're on the air.
Yeah, this is Matt.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was at the charity screening of the Star Wars over the weekend in Chicago.
Yeah.
And I was sitting right behind her, that Rosie.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And she was just like, I thought she was going to faint because she was like breathing so heavy and everything.
Hey, explain something to me. How does this woman have children? She's in Chicago on the weekends, and
it's very easy, Howard.
Yeah.
When you have all this help, you know, and the kids just sort of are flown in. You never really bore them or anything.
Yeah. I'm wondering how she travels so much being a single parent.
Yeah, what is she?
I'd like to ask her that.
Something to add to her conversation.
Billy, you're on the air.
Hey, Howard.
Yeah.
Not only is she a hypocrite, and I don't even want to swear, but anyway. Now she's a coward, too. She wouldn't even face you.
No.
You know,
yeah,
you went over there, she had all her people on her side, like she tag-teamed on poor Tom.
Right.
The audience was jumping in for her.
Yeah, did you hear all those people who were for me?
Yeah.
Applauding me.
Of course you were right.
I'll tell you why they were applauding me, because I at least went up there and made a point. Now, I'm going to tell you something. When that old security guard guy turned to me, he had a prepared statement. He said, Rosie O'Donnell will not allow you up. Then I tried to go up with this guy who had a pass.
Uh-huh.
He tried to take me up, but they wouldn't let me through. They had all their security people out in force. Nobody would allow me past the doors.
You know why that girl was yelling at you, right?
Which one?
The dyke that yelled at you.
No, she wasn't a dyke.
Sure she was.
Well, I don't know.
She was yelling. Why do you think she's on her side?
No, she wasn't yelling at me. Oh, you mean the one? Oh, that one. The one who said I was... Oh, yeah, that was probably a dyke. You're right.
Of course.
I thought you meant the reporter.
And her hand holds about 3,250 jelly beans.
Yeah, oh, please. Thank you. Neil, you're on the air.
Hi, Howard. I just wanted to say that when I was 17 years old, I used to go to K-Mart and buy CO2 cartridges and pellets for my pellet gun.
Of course.
Got to be 18 to do that, boss.
Right. I hear you.
And Rosie's sitting there talking how, you know, K-Mart's all good and, you know, plugging it and everything. But, no, that's not right.
Right. Chris, you're on the air.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hi, how are you? Love your show. Just calling to ask you, I was listening here. I'm from Toronto, and... When you were trying to get through security there?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I couldn't hear what happened, so I was just wondering what happened.
Yeah, I know. I had to switch to the telephone at that point. What happened was they had a barricade, a human barricade of security people who would not allow me pass because some guy had a pass and he tried to let me go in with him.
Right.
Because I was just going to go upstairs.
Right.
They would not let me through unless I started punching out some of the guards.
I know your show's not here in Toronto in 10 minutes, and I'm just wondering if they're even going to talk about that. It airs at 10 o'clock here, so I'm just wondering if they're even going to talk about that on her show. Right?
No, they won't. They won't even mention
me.
It'll
never be mentioned.
Because it's hypocritical for somebody to talk about gun control when K-Mart is selling guns and she's their representative.
If that audience had any sense, they would be screaming, Rosie, how can you work for K-Mart?
Yeah, right? they should,
you attack Tom Selleck?
There should be a mass pandemonium out there.
Yeah, here in Canada, when we had a couple of K-Marts, we don't have them anymore, but they didn't sell guns here.
And then Robin was just telling me in the news that literally while I was on there in Atlanta, some kids went in and shot up another school.
Right, yeah, I heard
you,
that.
A kid, apparently.
And I'll tell you why. That's because they're making it, listen, like Robin said to me in the commercial, the old days, if there was some tragedy like Columbine, mm-hmm. like it was sort of contained within that community, but now with mass communication and everything, they're making heroes out of these kids in a way because they give so much news time to it and everything. Mm-hmm. So these other now it's a copycat crime.
Right. Yeah,
now
they glorify it kind of.
Yeah.
A little bit. Like, you know, you get a little bit of attention, a little bit of media, so everybody hears it. And
yeah, so you get a couple of suicidal kids.
It's massive.
It's massive.
We get days and days and days. We know these kids' names.
So any kid who's thinking of committing suicide, instead of just committing suicide, he goes in and he blows everyone away.
That's kind of crazy.
Yeah.
Howard, I got one question for you.
Yeah.
You know your E show?
Yeah.
That only airs in the States, right?
I don't think it's on in Canada.
Can you get it in Canada? Is there any way you can try
to
get it?
No, please. They're trying to get me off the air in Canada. They already succeeded in getting me off the air in Montreal. Don't you think they're going to?
Well,
never
we're here in Toronto, and just let me tell you that you got tons of fans here, and I'd support you. I'd be your number one fan here in Toronto if anything tried to happen.
Thanks.
I listen to you every day. You got a great show.
Thanks, man.
And F Jackie.
Just trying to keep people entertained. That's all. Kim, you're on.
The only good thing about that trip over to Rosie was you almost lost Jackie.
Yeah. Jackie was scared, you said. It really was scary, wasn't it, Jack?
It was frightening.
I know. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I was watching and I was like, oh, my goodness.
Those guys.
It's bedlam over there.
They wield those cameras. Those press people wield those cameras like they're weapons.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they do. You know what? I probably
against you when you were getting out of the car.
I never expected so much press to be there, Robin. I think I could have had it. I don't say I would have gotten up to the Rosie O'Donnell show, but I could have perhaps made a better argument to the security people to at least call back up there.
Right.
But I couldn't even hear anything.
But now it was a building issue.
Yeah, it was getting to be dangerous, so I just left.
I couldn't believe even more people were inside the doors when you went in.
Yeah, because it's a public building; they got to let you in.
Wow.
I didn't know that. I just found that out.
Yeah, well, I thought about that as you were going in. I said, well, they have to let you in because it is one of the biggest tourist attractions in New York.
Yeah. Kim, you're on.
Hi, Howard.
Hi.
They should have let you in that building. She is a big, fat, bloated, big-headed hypocrite.
Of course.
They should have let you in there. She fears you.
Of course.
The only reason why they did not let you in there, she knows that you are right, and she's just a big, fat pig.
Yep.
Lying, Kmart-supporting, gun-selling pig.
Thank you. Thank you.
I support you 100%.
Thanks. Yeah, I knew she wouldn't let me up, but I just wanted to drive the point home. Thanks. Go ahead, Lorraine. You're on the air.
Howard.
Yeah.
Hi. What a thrill it is to speak with you.
Thanks.
I want to tell you, one of the things I love about you the most, and I love many things about you, is your integrity, which is more than I can say for some people.
Yeah, I'm not shilling from Kmart, that's for sure. And you know what? I wouldn't have any problem shilling from Kmart because I'm...
You don't make a big deal about guns.
No, I don't. I think if people want to, it's the Second Amendment, people are allowed to own them. I don't think that's why kids are shooting up schools. I mean, anybody can get a gun.
Right, we don't want to fix the kids. We want to make sure they can't get the guns to shoot us with.
Right.
I agree. We have guns. I don't. My husband and my children are not shooting people up, and they never will.
Yeah, because you're a sensible human being. Thank you.
They know not to touch them.
Right. Thanks.
I love you, Howard.
Love you.
Oh.
You don't even know how I would love you.
Howard.
Right.
What? You don't know. What it would be like for me to come up there and see you, bud.
You don't know what it would be like for me to sleep with you.
Yeah. Howard.
Can you imagine the two of us in bed nude?
Oh.
Yes.
Do me a favor. Please take off your clothes and rub the phone against your naked body.
Oh, okay.
Please.
Okay.
All right. Don't forget it. Doesn't do anything for me anyway. Hey, Jim.
Hey, how you doing?
What's happening?
Hey, that was a valiant attempt to get into the Rosie Fat Pig show.
It was wild.
Hey, Howard.
Yeah.
You know, it was great.
Right.
He fights. The crowd was getting bigger.
Yeah.
It really was getting a little scary.
I know. And
he fought his way all the way through, and finally we go barreling into the limo, and we're safe. It was in the window.
I know. Ronnie lets the window down.
Ronnie rolled the whole window down.
I was like, what happened? There's a big hole in the
window. Somebody could have punched out right
there. You're rolling the whole window down.
What happened to him? He lost it.
He did. He cracks. Because he wants to be a security guy more than he wants to be a limo driver.
And finally he got his chance.
Yeah.
And what does he do?
He rolled
that. He gets you safe and he opens the window.
So anybody can get in.
Want that down?
Hey, Ronnie, you want to come in and explain that?
Thought you wanted to find it right now, Howard.
Are you?
Yeah, I think he's in the green room having a cigarette.
Yeah, get him in here.
All his nerves.
I thought you wanted some air.
I leaned on
get him in
elbow.
Here. Want to find out what happened.
Security.
All I know was I finally get in the car and roll down the window.
I was sitting there. Why? Because it was on TV. Yeah. And all of a sudden, I'm like, oh, he's finally safe. And then all of a sudden, the whole window was open.
He cracked.
Everybody's screaming. I mean, Ronnie didn't even know.
You see how it's not easy to be a cop even? Like, imagine if Ronnie had a gun.
Oh, wow. Oh boy.
You know what I'm saying?
Everybody would have been gone.
You know, you talk about those cops who, like, shot up that guy 41 times. That's how it happened.
Yeah.
Just get in trouble. You just keep shooting.
We've been stepping over pipes.
Howard.
Yeah.
Well, I was in Texas, unfortunately, a few months ago visiting someone, and I went into a Kmart with my sister. You can actually buy a Glock 9mm with nothing more than a driver's license.
We had some guy here who's not even an American citizen went in and bought a Glock the other day from Kmart.
Yeah,
exactly. So, yeah. I mean...
What is it, Gary?
The funny thing, Ronnie's always here.
Yeah.
I can't find him now.
He ran out.
He grabbed a cigarette off me, and that was the last I saw of him.
Yeah, he ran.
He's
still running.
Lest anybody think that was a joke, it wasn't.
Just see the look on your face when that window went down.
Oh, I was like, wait a second. First, I was ready to blame you, because it's always Baba Booey. And I realized Baba Booey can't control my window. There's only one guy.
You know, there were two moments. First, everybody else got out of the car once you were there, including Ronnie.
Yeah.
And then they wouldn't open the door for you.
Yeah, because I couldn't open the door. My hands were full with equipment. That's the other thing with our equipment.
I was standing outside, and then nobody would open the door.
Couldn't Dougie just throw that thing in my pocket so I could at least...
Well, you did. You put it in your pocket.
No, I didn't have a pocket.
It was always in his hand.
No. Walking around like a bag lady trying to...
Because he was setting you up while you were talking on air. I think he was afraid to start touching you.
Well, he could touch me. I'm not Rosie.
And then when you're trying to get back in the car, Ronnie opens the window and lets everybody see.
Just in case there was somebody who wanted to get in. Mickey, go ahead.
Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's Aaron. What's up?
Oh, Aaron, go ahead.
Yeah, I just want to commend you, Howard, because I think ever since the movie came out, you know, it's been a while since you went out and, like, confronted someone on your own, and you went up to Rosie like a man, and, well, you tried to, and that fat bitch wouldn't let you up there.
Well, what can you do, man? Thank you. I don't know what the movie correlates to, but...
Well, because, you know...
Dude, I've been in more trouble since that movie than 10 people getting in a lifetime, so...
Well, no,
if you're making a point that somehow I won't confront people, I don't know.
Well, no, I'm not saying that. Just since the movie, it's like you've just blown up and there's so much overexposure that you really can't go anywhere.
Yeah, well, yeah, that's the truth. Because...
who knew that just because you said you were going over there, everybody in the city would be over there?
Yeah, I never saw so much. Oh, here's Ronnie. Ronnie, what happened? The key moment was we're pulling away...
Have you regained your composure?
What did you do? You went and smoked? You don't even smoke. What, you had a cigarette?
Yeah, I need a little calming.
Give that man some Valium.
What happened?
Quiet for me. He says to me, I got to get a shot of Howard pulling away. He says, put the window down.
Oh.
No.
Yeah.
And he doesn't come in here and fess up?
That's why you rolled down the window?
Yeah. I just,
and you allowed
like,
that?
Real quick, you know.
But why don't you talk to me before you do that?
I know.
Is that really the truth?
Yeah.
And you allowed that?
No. Mr. Security?
What happened?
I don't know. It was just like everything was so...
Mr. Lincoln, would you stand up in your seat?
Wait, the guys asked you for a shot of me in the car?
Our guys.
So why'd you let it?
It's all guys, man. It wasn't the guys.
But there were 5,000 people around.
Everything was cool. The cops were out there.
Why don't you tell me so I'm ready for the shot?
I had the cops standing out
there. The cops were not near the window.
Yes, they were. I had the highway cops standing there.
You're out of your mind.
The whole thing. They were at the front of the car where you were.
You're nuts.
Come on.
All right, go smoke a cigarette.
I'm not smoking. Why didn't Brian come in and fess up? Now I get in trouble for his garbage now?
Just because Brian tells you to do something, don't do it.
Look at his stupid new haircut. Get in here.
Here's Kmart's Great Outdoor Adventure Sale. $89.99. You can buy a Savage 22 caliber rifle.
Savage.
$129.99. You get a Remington 22 caliber autoloader rifle with synthetic stock. This is Rosie O'Donnell's company.
Uh-huh.
$179.99. A Mossberg 500 12-gauge shotgun. Featuring a 3-inch chamber, hardwood stock. Look at this stuff
good
you can
stuff,
buy.
Good stuff.
Buy all kinds of stuff. Who's she kidding? Hey, Brian.
Hey, my fault. Sorry.
What are you rolling? It's his fault, too. Yeah. You don't have to listen to Brian.
Yeah, but I needed the shot, man. It was like,
What was the shot? What shot did you get?
Well, he was talking. The car was still there, so I figured maybe...
The beginning, he was in the car with me.
I didn't realize that. There was, you know, it was a... pig F of people, so I knew what was going on. I figured.
Yeah. Once I'm in the car, you don't roll down the window.
I had the best.
I know that. I know that.
So why'd you do it?
I mean, yeah, did you see what was going on?
If you know that, why'd you do it?
I knew what was going on out there. You were sitting up here.
Let me ask you something.
I definitely know what
was going
on.
I had to tell you.
I respect
you. Down the window.
You're my friend for how long?
14 years.
Yeah, we've been doing this.
Right.
Why do you roll down the window then if you knew that?
Of course, I thought the guy really needed the shot. Okay?
Oh.
Oh, yeah, we would have had a shot of him.
No. I would,
we
if
knew
I
Howard was in the car.
Kind of
all right,
over
thank
there,
you. All right,
what
you
is
go.
The shot he's talking about?
Who knows?
Ask Brian.
Did you get the shot?
Yeah, I got the shot.
Good.
Right. Give me that shot. I want to see that.
Why don't you guys smoke some weed? Go ahead, get out of here.
You want a cigarette?
Yeah, Melissa, go ahead. You're on the air. Lee Harvey Mund is with me. Yeah, go ahead.
Come on.
Rosie's private office number.
What was that again? You better start again.
I had her office number.
Rosie?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I called to ask if they were going to let you up, and they were having all sorts of meetings about it, and basically said that they weren't going to let you up, that Rosie had a show to do. And
yeah, well, the show would have been great if I was on it.
Right, Miss Spontaneity.
Yeah, if she had some balls, instead of Tom Selleck, who's comparable to having a wall on, it would add
she avalanches, she blindsides.
Did you see the interview?
It shows you, I heard it. As long as the fight is stacked in her favor,
right,
she'll do
talk
it.
To you.
Yeah.
Well, I have the office number, and I called back and asked why he wouldn't talk to her, and they asked me how I got the number, and this is her private office. And
now they're coming after you.
And they can't comment on that, and they have nothing to say.
Yeah. All right. Whatever. I went over there. I made my point. Thank you.
I have one more question.
Yeah.
Do you still have the Emmy contest?
I don't know. Oh, yeah.
The Emmy tickets?
Yeah. Emmy tickets?
Yeah. Tomorrow, okay? We're just a little backed up now.
Okay.
All right, later. Yeah.
Huh, you don't want Rosie's office number?
No, what am I going to do with that? They're not going to talk.
Call over again. Mm. See what you get. Mm. I like to book an appointment since I couldn't just drop up.
Yeah. See, I only want to do shows where there's conference. Like, I want to do the Magic Johnson show.
Because there was controversy.
Yeah. And that show I'll do.
Actually, you were trying to save that show because you were so enjoying it.
I miss it. I swear there isn't a day that goes by I don't miss the Magic Johnson show.
Every late night now.
Well, you and I used to have an hour of material from that show every day. I really miss it. What are you going to do? You want to do the news? Let's take a break. We'll do the news when we get back and see what else is going on. We'll be back right after these words.
Howard Stern's outrageous antics always shock America.
You are listening to The Howard Stern Show.
Howard sure paints quite a picture.
The Howard Stern Show. You're listening to The Howard Stern Show.
All right. Well, pretty emotional morning as I went to the streets. Some guy has a tape on the phone. He says Rosie O'Donnell just, like, explained the Tom Selleck thing. I don't mind listening to it, but I just listen for the band leader to see what he says while she talks. That's what I want to hear. That guy's got some gig.
Do you think he's even awake?
I don't know. She needs to talk to him for some reason. Like, she needs someone to connect with, but he is, like, such wallpaper. Like, why is he there?
I don't think he's awake when he does this.
Hi, Robert.
Yeah, hi.
Hey.
Unfortunately, the band leader doesn't say much.
That's exactly what I'm talking about.
Yeah, she just uses the usual backpedaling.
Yeah, mostly she does a monologue and he makes noises.
I was thinking something else, like, because we just tuned in to Rosie O'Donnell, but she's not doing any. We missed this part, so now it's just back to our regular boring show, but she didn't mention, of course, the fact that I tried to confront her.
Oh, no. No way.
Didn't bring that up at all. That didn't happen.
And the show's live, and she didn't mention the Atlanta shootings, but I think that's because she has to wait for somebody to script it for her.
Right. She doesn't know how she feels yet. She's so passionate.
Right.
Actually, she does mention the Atlanta shooting.
Oh, she does?
I'll play it for you, okay?
All right.
Rosie and Tom will have a discussion about the NRA. And I honestly, my intent was to have a calm discussion about the NRA.
Right. I know.
It didn't end up calm.
The band leader.
I started out good. I gave him 4 minutes to talk, and then I had the questions, which are the issues that concern me about the NRA. Not the individuals in the NRA. I do not think the people who are members of the NRA are bad people.
Right. Yes, you do.
Law-abiding gun owners are evil or bad, right. But the lobbying efforts of the NRA are startling.
Well,
they are against the ban.
NRA are the people in the NRA.
They are against mandatory safety locks on guns. They are against waiting periods for handgun purchases. They are against registration of second-party sales, and they are against the banning of top-killer bullets. That's bullets that pierce...
Make it louder.
That's what the lobbying effort of the NRA does. Those are the issues that I wanted to bring up. Of course, my heart starts beating very fast, and I get very passionate about the subject. I do not think that Tom Selleck was prepared for me to be as opinionated and as passionate as I was yesterday. And for that, I think he was very surprised. Although he did know we were going to discuss the NRA, I do not...
Do you hear this?
No.
The
it was started out good. Hey, dude.
Yeah.
We can't hear it. You lowered it.
I strongly do apologize to him personally, but I do not apologize for my feelings about this issue, because the NRA is the strongest lobby, many people say, in Washington, and they are also, according to many studies, a minority. And that the people who feel strongly against what the NRA stands for in their lobbying efforts need to be heard as well. And many people are afraid to take a stand against them because they're so powerful. So that's what happened yesterday. And
what does that mean?
It is never my intent to embarrass or humiliate any of the guests on our show. And the fact that I am aware from the phone calls that we got from his publicist that he felt both of those things. And for that, as a personal level, I do apologize to him. I assumed
the guy looked like an idiot.
Meant that he was ready to discuss the issues of the NRA.
Right.
But he was not. And we did make it clear to him. And that's all I'm going to say on the subject.
He says he was never told they were going to talk about the NRA.
Why he was a bad man, we have very differing beliefs on the issue of gun control. Speaking of which, and not implying that they are in any way involved in this, but for the information of the studio audience who was in line when this happened, there has been another school shooting today in Atlanta. A student walked in and shot between 4 and 5 students in his school, and so far there are no reported deaths, but 4 or 5 students are injured, and the student who shot them has been taken into custody. That's what I have to say about that. At some point, we as a society have to do something.
Preacher.
All right. Now we'll move on.
What is she going to do?
We as a society.
Yeah. We're going to... So why is she...
She can't even talk to you.
She does.
Society will never get together.
She said the extremes have to talk. I want to ask her why she... I think she's pro-gun. I think she's selling guns at K-Mart. I still don't understand where the answer is on that. That's what I'm trying to figure out. I don't mind you being anti-gun, but put your money where your mouth is and cancel that K-Mart ad. She's weird. And she's gotten into this we. She's referring to herself as we. Did you catch that?
She's as big as we.
But I like the band. Yeah, she's as big as two people.
Maybe that's what she means.
Yeah, maybe she's being accurate. And then the band leader, I like him. He's like,
You're right.
Because Rosie goes, and you know, when I feel passionate about something, my heart starts beating faster. Yeah. I would love to put together a tape of just him. Yeah. And does he automatically agree with everything she says?
Yeah.
It's like, maybe he's pro-gun. Yeah. Maybe he's in the NRA.
Yeah, you never know.
He's like on the phone and says, get me out of the goddamn NRA.
Howard, when you were at Rockefeller Center, Tom Selleck was also on Live with Kathy and Lee Just Free. I got a tape of that as well. He unfortunately has laryngitis, and they asked him about what happened yesterday. Give that a listen?
Yeah, he's probably all upset.
Yeah, here we go.
You're calling to Rosie, and I know her heart's in the right place, but you know when you have your own show, and she does, and so I have, and you have.
It sounds like Christopher Reeve says you've been beat up. To
you, and they probably won't tell you when you're out of line. Unfortunately, I think it was an example of the kind of moral vanity and intolerance that is all too often fueling our political
debate. A battered man.
I'm sure she's sorry.
I think she tried this issue. I saw it this morning. I saw a tape of it. I know her heart. She was right after Columbine. She was, you were gone. Mm-hmm. You couldn't make it back.
That's right.
She guest hosted with us that day. And she was so passionate about it.
Shut up.
And so are you. That's right. But I think that's what makes our country great. We're all allowed to be passionate about how we feel and still get along.
So anyway.
I love your movie. How about that? I love your new movie.
I love that movie.
There's
another person who won't talk to you because of your views.
Yeah.
And she says, but that's what makes our country wonderful.
And she won't talk to me.
Bring views and I'll get along.
Rosie O'Donnell won't talk to me. Kathy Lee won't talk to me. But they're talking about tolerance and talking to other people.
Yeah. So funny.
Yeah. Hypocrites.
Such hypocrites. Yeah. You're right.
Yeah. You want to talk to... They never put their money where their mouth is. Kathy Lee's another one. And she's in love with everybody. But meanwhile, she's got children sewing those stupid-ass clothes ours. You know? As schmatas of fat, ugly women. I think they're going to look like Kathy Lee. Ugh. What a joke.
Why don't you try to get Tom Selleck on? He's in town.
Yeah, no, because I'm honest. I'm going to ask him tough questions.
Yeah.
He actually would have had a good time here.
He has no voice left anyway.
Hey, here's something. Forget it. Kathy Lee makes me want to vomit. I can tolerate Rosie more than I can Kathy Lee. Did you hear that?
We know. She was so passionate.
She was just so upset about Columbine. And Tom Selleck, you know, so was I. What am I, the devil?
Yeah. Nobody cares but Rosie.
Right.
Like, Kathy Lee was, oh, yeah, it didn't really matter to me, but she didn't really care about
Columbine. She really cared about Columbine. And then you know that you care as well. And what's so great about America is that we can all view our opinions and air our opinions. Shut up.
Her heart really is in the right place.
Good. Big fat heart. I've seen her by the pool at the Four Seasons. Her heart is not in the right place.
It's in the same place Gabby Lee.
Yeah, that's a woman who hates people. She might love humanity, but hates people.
Now, how do you do that?
Yeah. Oh, please. Plenty of people do that. They love talking about how human beings should behave and act, but when it comes down to actually interacting with them, they all wish they were dead.
Police.
Well, see, that sort of smacks of hypocrisy. Yeah.
Well, that's what I'm telling you. When you see somebody sitting by a pool growling at human beings and berating the staff, you know there's something wrong. You know. Anyway, later, dude.
Okay, thanks.
Thanks for the tape. Right. That was good. Yeah, John. Hello? Yeah.
Yes.
Ray.
Hello?
Yeah, hi, you're on the air.
Yes, hello, how are you? Is this Howard?
Yeah, it's Howard, you're on the air.
Hi, Howard, how are you? This is John McNeil. I was Rosie's hairdresser from August 1993 to October 12th of 94, and she is a royal bitch. Two scratches in the eyes, very bad.
Well, John, no offense.
I don't know.
We don't know if you're really John McNeil.
I can give you the number where I'm working at, whatever you're comfortable with.
I don't even know if you're really.
But we had a producer by the name of Lisa Randall, and every time she would walk by while I was doing Rosie's hair, Rosie sure enough would say, look at that ass. I would like to have a piece of it.
Well, I don't know.
100% likes women.
Well, I don't know. I can't put that. You know, I got to say that I don't know if that's true or not.
This is the opinion of the caller.
Yeah, I'm not saying you're lying, but I don't know if you are or not. Okay, dude?
Well, whatever you're comfortable with, Howard. Doesn't right. matter to me. I could do whatever you want. Just
We're
tell
comfortable
me.
With you going away. Now.
All right, thanks, John.
Right. Super duper.
Right, bye.
Two snaps and a jump.
All right. Once again, we don't know if that's the real guy.
Yeah, who knows what's going on?
Who knows what's going on there?
Rosie's bed, and we don't know.
Right, we don't know.
What the hell?
I would have asked her.
Heard of her dating.
I would have gone on the show. Well, on her show, because I just tuned in, but I tuned in late. She was there throwing kisses to a picture of Tom Cruise. And I wonder how much of that is real. Like, is she really attracted to him? I don't know. I don't know. And who cares? I just wanted to go confront her about this K-Mart thing, which she still hasn't addressed on her show.
Yes, you can talk about everything else. Why not that?
Yeah.
What's wrong with that audience that they don't even ask these questions?
What's wrong with that audience that they didn't stand up and walk out? First of all, why are you asking Tom Selleck about the NRA? Like, why him? Why not have a representative of the NRA?
Since he said, I am the NRA in his ad, he was ready to discuss the issues. That's BS.
Well, since she's on the K-Mart commercial, yeah, she was all set up for him.
Yeah.
And hey, wait a second. She is K-Mart.
That's right. Let's talk to her about their policy.
Yeah.
She's so passionate. Get somebody from the NRA to do a whole show.
Right. She's not passionate. She just wants to set up stupid Tom Selleck. She knows he's dumb. Everyone in Hollywood knows Tom Selleck doesn't have a brain in his head.
She probably doesn't like him.
Everybody knows it. Everybody knows he's not bright. That's not right.
That's not fair.
I ain't saying I'm a genius, but I'll tell you one thing. I'll go on there. I ain't going to sit back like Tom Selleck.
Nobody had given her notes on you, boy. She wasn't coming near you.
Nope.
Not happening.
It's not going to happen.
We have been informed.
See you off the floor.
Yeah. I don't think you want to check Tom Selleck's SAT scores. I don't think you find a lot going on up there. What?
How do you spell SAT?
Well. Anyway. Mm-hmm. So there it is. Our big Rosie O'Donnell day. I was down there today.